I'ma slide anytime you want. Put you in Chanel, I'ma teach you how to stand. 21. Slip and slide like a waterfall. You need some TLC, we can creep if you want. 21. Hey, turn your phone off, take your clothes off. 21. I'm a savage, but I fuck her to a slow song. 21. Turn the lights down, 21. Lay the pipe down. 21. I ain't Mr. Right, but I'm Mr. Right now. Straight up. She want me to fuck her to Beyonce. Straight up. But I don't treat her like she my fiance. Girl. Make that thing sing like Sade. 1942, it ain't no Chardonnay. 21. In a lounge truck, yeah, with my Richard on. Yeah. Got a pretty girl 21. That I'm feeling on. 21. We in quarantine, God. But my M's long. God. But it lame, he got friends on. God. Got a couple spots, 21. And they all on. 21. Bought a penthouse, 21. Cause I'm never home. God. Threw my heart out the window, feelings gone. 21. Threw my heart out the window, but I'ma slide anytime you want. 21. Put you in Chanel, I'ma teach you how to stand. God. Slip and slide like a waterfall. Straight up. You need some TLC, we can creep if you want. Straight up. Hey, turn your phone off. Straight up. Take your clothes off. Straight up. I'm a savage, but I fuck her to a slow song. Straight up. Turn the lights down. Straight up. Lay the pipe down. Straight up. I ain't Mr. Right, but I'm Mr. Right now. 21.
Turn your phone off. Take your clothes off. I'm a sad, but I fuck her to a slow song. Said the nail lady went and did her toes wrong. Said the last man was always playing Drake songs. Yeah, cell phones out when I roll up. Yeah, the nigga had a problem till I showed up. Everybody with an app before they name tough. Yeah, more concerned with blowing up than growing up. Yeah, said she wanna fuck to some scissor weight. Cause I used to date scissor back in 08. If you cool with it, baby, she can still play. While I jump inside that box and have a field day. I'm a slow stroke king, hit me anytime. And my goal is to get you to the finish line. I seen good movies and bad plenty times. So let me finish strong, girl.
I'ma slide anytime you want. Put you in Chanel, I'ma teach you how to stand. God. Slip and slide like a waterfall. You need some TLC, we can creep if you want.
If you want.
Hey, turn your phone off. Girl. Take your clothes off. Girl. I'm a savage, but I fuck her to a slow song. Girl. Turn the lights down. Girl. Lay the pipe down. Girl. I ain't Mr. Right, but I'm Mr. Right now. 21. She want me to fuck her to some key sweat. 21. But she stay in apartments, I got beef at. Girl. Pussy so good, I had to sneak back. Girl. Hit her with my glizzy, boy, I keep that.
You fuck with the ones that fuck with you. What, the niggas, the dumbass bitches want to come up and lay up and give you some pussy at 12, 1 o'clock at night, face ass nigga, do I look dumb, stupid, or slow? Nigga, please, what the fuck is you talking about? Just like you want to stick a dick off at me, I want some motherfucking money. And don't get in your motherfucking feelings when you see me in the motherfucking club randomly and one of your niggas want to get down on me. And I want to get us some pussy because that gave me some money. That, I mean, that's easy.
I want to know who motherfucking representing it here tonight. Hold on, hold on.
I keep letting you back in. How can I explain myself? You said you care for me, care for me.
Louisiana shit. Murder on the beat. Something for y'all to cut up to, you know? Yeah. Everybody get your motherfucking roll on. I know shorty and she doesn't want no slow song. Had a man last year, life goes on. Haven't let the thing loose, girl, in so long. You been inside, know you like to lay low. I been peeping what you bringing to the table. Working hard, girl, everything paid for. First, last phone bill, car, no cable. With your phone out, gotta hit them angles. With your phone out, snapping like you Fabo. And you showing off, but it's alright. And you showing off, but it's alright. It's a short life, yeah. That's a real one in your reflection. Without a follow, without a mention. You really piping up on these niggas. You gotta be nice for what to these niggas? I understand. You got a 100 bands, you got a baby Benz. You got some bad friends, high school pics. You was even bad then. You ain't stressing off no lover in the past tense. You already had them. Work at 8 a.m., finish round 5. Post talk down, you don't see them outside. Yeah, they don't really be the same off
alright. And you're showing off, but it's alright. It's a short life.
These hoes. Your boy. I'm A.
Watch the breakdown.
Yeah. Okay. Lil CC on a beat. Yeah, yeah. I mean, where the fuck should I really even start? I got hoes that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my niggas cross the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead, thought my raps wasn't facts till they sat with the bars. I got two phones, one need a charge. Yeah, they twins, I could tell they ass apart. I got big packs coming on the way. I got big stacks coming out to save. I got Lil Max with me, he the wave. It's a big gap between us and the game. In the next life, I'm trying to stay paid. When I die, I put my money in the grave. When I die, I put my money in a grave. I really gotta put a couple niggas in a place. Really just lapped every nigga in a race. I really might tap realest nigga on my face. Lil CC, let it slap with the bass. I used to save hoes with a mask in a cave. Now I'm like, nah, love, I'm good, go away. Ain't about to die with no money I done gave you. I was on top when that shit meant a lot. Still on top like I'm scared of the drop. Still on top and these niggas wanna swap. Niggas wanna swap like it's lost in a watts. I don't wanna change cause I'm good where I'm at. Mob tie, so I'm always good where I'm at. Word of Junior, Jazzy, Baby J. Tell him when I die, put my money in a crack.
Couple figures, kill a skull and collect. She fuck a nigga, then she on to the next. Really living large, she in all with a Mac. When you niggas thinking small in a mall with a rat. Roll with us if you really wanna get it. Go get a half a million in a Sprinter. Phone ringing, bitches know a big tipple. I got the hook up and there really no limit. Dead broke is in you nigga DNA. Ricky Smiley syndicated with the yay. Lil nigga just another state case. Bury mine, motherfucker Chase Bank, time to bounce. Gotta count on my allowance. You niggas snitching, so I gotta rewrite it. A nigga dripping like I got a zillion dollars. Got the trap jumping like Zion when I rebound. Then I'm out, and I never talk about it. The homie squad, but we all smoke the loudest. Rich niggas and I'm really being modest. Cause the way I do my deals, never treated like an artist. Want a house, you could DM my account.
Oh, when did you guys walk in? I didn't know you came. My apologies. I was just drinking a vodka cranberry, you know, it's the holidays and everything. It seems appropriate. Although, I do know why you guys are here. Vim has asked me for your help. I know. Why would he ask me? I don't know either, but he does need help. You see this big button right up here? I know it's up there. I know you guys see it. It says subscribe. And Vim needs you guys to do that. He needs you guys to subscribe. But you guys also need him. Maybe you don't have $5 a month. Maybe you don't have $15, $25, whatever tier you want to buy. Maybe you just don't have the money this month. Look no further. Do you have Amazon Prime? Because I know you do, because I do too. It 2-day shipping, everybody loves it. You can subscribe right now for free. For free! With Twitch Prime. I know you might want to use it on another streamer, but this is the streamer you have to use it on. Because without him, we can't do anything. He cannot stream anymore if you don't subscribe. So please, 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 just hit that purple button. Just hit it! And we can continue streaming on Twitch. Please, it's the holidays. Just Twitch Prime now. Thank you. I have to get back to my party. But to everybody, Merry Twitch Primeness.
I forgot.
Hello?
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 Yeah,
hello?
Aloha.
Hello? Hello? Is this thing on?
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah,
hello?
Yeah,
yo.
Who is that? Who is that? Butte.
Yo, look at this, bro. Repping the Uncle Vim merch. What can I say?
Damn. You designed that yourself?
Yeah, bro.
Yeah.
Actually, somebody helped us design it, but, you know.
I know. I did.
Yeah.
You're right.
Of course. Anyways, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the one and only BattriCast podcast. We're back.
Yeah.
5 weeks in a row.
Hey,
let's get into this. All right, let's get right into
I haven't been here.
Oh, yeah, we got a first timer, so let's get into the
introduction. Wait, is it his first time?
Yeah, it's his first time, dude.
Yeah.
Last time I talked to Bryce was probably unpopular opinion time, maybe. Long time ago.
But that was 3 years.
3 years? Whoa, it's not that long ago.
Chill. I know I was hibernating, but I wasn't hibernating for that long.
Exactly.
Oh, I know, man. It was pretty long.
Yeah. It's definitely been a while.
Effect. That's okay, though.
But yeah, it's okay.
I mean, when's the last time we heard his voice? Yeah, it's okay. But like, I think it would genuinely be like almost a year.
I guess. I mean, I've definitely missed you, Bryce. I've definitely missed you, bro.
100%. Introductions first.
Yeah, let's get through these introductions.
Yeah,
Erik.
Introductions.
Erik, go ahead and take it away, brother. You're up first.
Welcome. Wait, you didn't even intro us back.
Yeah, you gotta do the intros, bro. You gotta introduce yourself.
I'm doing the intro this week. Damn. Welcome back to the BattriCast.
True. Let's go. Round of applause, boys. Round of applause.
My name is Erik, if you did not know that, and now you do. And today we are repping OVO boys once again.
The OVO boys are back.
Gang things. To my right, I have the one and only Pierre.
Hey, hey Pierre. What's poppin', brother?
Hey, come out here, brother.
Kakota, brother.
And to his right, we have the CEO of Misogyny, foreshadowing right there.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Vim, aka the CEO of Misogyny. We got some hot topics today, hot takes. So, yeah, let's get this.
Below me, we have the special guest of the night, Big Dick Bryce.
Aloha.
Bringing back the old nickname, eh?
Yes.
Let's go.
And let's beside go. Him, we have CEO of Hot Takes.
It's your boy.
Yo, what's Klaus, what's poppin', brother?
Jeez.
No fucking way.
Can
watch.
I be the CEO of
the weather's nice? That's about it.
Yeah, you can do
you
that.
You can be the CEO of whatever you want, brother.
Yeah.
Yo, Klaus, so, Klaus, where were you last week, bro? We missed you on the show.
Bro, I was being fucking depressed in my bed. Shit like that.
True.
That's makes sense. Know? True. You know, it's relatable. Agree.
Anyways. I guess we'll do the basic thing that we do every week. Anybody have any interesting stories or anything from this week or
I sold 11K in chocolate yesterday.
Dude, I don't understand your job, man. Like how do you guys actually manage to sell like overpriced chocolate?
I'm goaded, that's why.
Okay, whatever you say.
Yeah, whatever you say, man. Hey.
Alright. We did like 60,000.
How much of that money did you take in person?
Yeah, of chocolate?
It wasn't chocolate. It was okay.
It's okay.
It's not that impressive, let's be honest then. Yikes.
But,
60, wow. Thanks for ruining the fucking mood, Pierre. God damn.
Like, I don't even know what to say at this point.
My 60K is not impressive.
Man's just down bad. He's just fucking kicking it in the teeth. What are you saying?
No.
I'll flex on all
compared to 11K in chocolates?
Oh, he's going
to
flex on all of us.
Yeah, I think the person here who's made the most money ever is probably Bryce. And,
hey, I mean, yes. fuck you. But yes, but no. The reason why I was gonna flex was, hey, at least you aren't getting limited by the Australian government to one wine bottle a day. This is a deprivation against Bryce Kind. I literally every single night I sit in the tub and I'm drinking the wine. And I'm just like, I wish I had one more.
I think you got a problem there, buddy. Like, I don't know about
it. I think there's a reason why.
That's a bit suspicious, man. Like,
that's a little sus.
Your kidney's okay. Like,
no. It's really... But what I drink is, like, really low, so it doesn't matter. So I have to drink, too. Otherwise, it doesn't get me anyway.
Just look.
Hey, I mean, to each their own. Pierre, how was your week,
good,
brother?
Big bottle.
My week was... Dude, it was just chill. I just worked. Just, like, worked a lot, so... I didn't do anything. No, nothing exciting.
True.
Nothing.
I guess I pretty much worked. I think I worked Wednesday, Thursday, Friday this week. And then today was my dad's birthday. So happy birthday to dad.
Happy birthday to the OG.
Uncle Vim Pog.
Happy birthday, daddy.
And yeah, so I went out and got some presents. I actually bought myself a new stuffed animal to join the collection of Canadian stuffed animals that I own.
Oh, God.
There's a little beaver. This is my boy right here.
He's got that merch, man.
Jesus.
Yo. I love collecting these like Canadian themed teddy bears. I think they're cute.
It's just like me collecting Pokemon cards.
Yeah, exactly. There you go.
And me collecting
wine bottles.
People in money. My basement.
Oh, people in your basement. Wine bottles.
Wine bottles.
For
sure.
No, 100%. Wine bottles.
It's definitely. Yeah, I call them. Yeah. The metaphor is wine bottles, but in reality, that
It's not children. It is. It's a wine cellar on paper, but you know.
Yes.
It's a dungeon, otherwise.
Exactly. There you go.
It's deep. Things are getting strewn about like a birthday banner. Don't worry.
So, I guess.
Go ahead. I hit a plate on my bench press this week.
Oh yeah, so I heard.
Four years to get there. Yeah.
Yo, big up Erik. He's finally catching up in terms of lifting. Erik, how much do you weigh again?
I weigh a total of 135.
Exactly. So you're benching body weight.
Yes.
That's huge.
That's amazing. That's good. He's pound for pound now. I mean, that's amazing.
That's what people like, should be able to do, right? 130
pounds? Or what? Yeah,
pounds,
kg?
Pounds.
Yeah, yeah.
Pounds. Okay. I have to calculate 1 second.
That's like... Actually, I don't know.
Well, one plate's...
He's probably like 60 kilos.
You know what's really funny? Both the Australians are on the bottom of the screen, and then all the NA people are on the top.
Yeah.
I think that's how it should be. Yeah. Anyways.
I thought we were past this in 2020. Honestly, you should know better, Vim.
I'm kidding, brother.
Background,
you know,
and all. Not accepting it. Cancel Vim.
Cancel Vim. Yeah, what's up, brother?
Saying we should dive right into this week's misogyny hours.
I mean, I think the person who had the biggest week this week was probably Pokimane. Because of all those leaked documents, but we'll get to that later, right? Because I'm pretty sure not everybody is like brushed up with the whole like leaked documents manipulation, ruthless businesswoman stuff. Yeah. But we'll talk in more general terms, right?
Yeah.
So, Erik, you know what? I wanted you to lead today's podcast because of this one person who is in one of your classes.
All right, so. Good thing no one in my class is watching right now. All right.
Oh, geez. So,
damn, what do you mean? You were supposed to paste.
We have this Discord. You were supposed to send
the Twitch link to that Discord and straight up subtweet her live, bro.
Fim, quick question.
Okay, I'll do that right now.
Yeah, hold up. Wait, Bryce has a question. What's up, buddy?
Why is there two big dick Bryces on the stream?
What? What?
There's two.
What?
What?
Oh,
if you look at the name.
Oh, whoops.
That's me, but I am though.
We have an imposter.
There's no imposter among us. Don't worry about it.
Oh my god. I'll fix this.
I'm the real one.
Oh, really? Okay, just give me 1 second. No, I'm kidding.
How did I mess this up? Okay. Erik, take it away.
Well, there's this shorty in our Discord chat. It's for our class, right? She's always like, she hates my existence because I'm from Toronto, okay? She just hates me. And then so this past week, she's just like, shut up,
woman,
with me, right?
Shut up, woman.
And then I'm like, what did I do? I'm not even paying attention because we're in our tutorial. And then she's like, oh, you're just talking out of nowhere. I don't know. And then I told her, right? I'm like, suck me off or shut the fuck up. Right?
Wait, dude, you gotta give us some more backstory, man. Like
backstory,
like we gotta get the intimate details.
Intimate details. So this is a Lebanese chick.
That's not right? Intimate
that
enough.
Anything. Lebanese. It doesn't have to do with anything.
No, I'm just like creating the picture for you guys. You know.
Oh, he's painting a picture.
Psychological
for us,
profile, yeah. Man. What kind of childhood did she have? What's her address, man?
She. Whoa. She's from Ottawa. She grew up around white people. No offense.
True.
Mm-hmm. We're
white people.
I take offense, but go ahead.
Fuck.
She's very, I guess she's very much a snowflake. Yeah. what, how intimate do you want it? Like,
I just need, like,
down to the freckles.
No.
To the freckles.
Man. No, I just want you to give, like, a basis of, like, what your relationship is like with her and, like, what it's like to talk with her and stuff. And then, just give us some backstory on, like, why she hates you and then go into, like, this week's work and stuff.
Apparently, she hates me because I'm from Toronto, boys. I'm from Toronto, and she hates me because I'm from Toronto.
That's the only reason.
Yeah.
America.
Like, mm-hmm.
You're also
Canada.
Yeah, we're Canadian. No,
Canada,
so.
Whatever, you're close enough.
So, and we're thinking, me and Vim came up with this collective idea that people from Ottawa, is where I am right now, hate Toronto people because they're just jealous of us.
True.
Because we live such a better lifestyle here.
And I don't think it's just people from Ottawa. I think it's generally, like, anybody who's not from Toronto. Like, whenever I go up to people and say, like, yo, I'm from Toronto, they'll be like, oh, so you're from Brampton. Brampton's, like, known for just having, like, a bunch of brown people. And I'd be like, no, I'm actually from, like, Toronto. Like, I grew up, like, literally in the hood. And then they just get jealous. Like, literally a bunch of my friends in like, first year, they'd always tease me because my parents lived in Hamilton. They moved while I was in... while I was at college or university, whatever. And they'd always be like, nah, he's from Hamilton, as if, like, it was a way to, like, gain clout over me to just say that I'm not from Toronto, or to convince people that I'm lying that I'm from Toronto. But, like, to this day, I've lived the longest time in Toronto. I grew up in Toronto, so that's where I say I'm from, you know what I mean?
I'm not even from Toronto. I just say I'm from Toronto. But anyways.
True.
I don't know anything about Toronto, so I can't talk.
So, it would be, like, equivalent to saying, like, you're from Boston, right?
Yeah. Well, I'm not from Boston, though. I'm from, outside of Boston.
Like, where are you
from? Well, it'll be equivalent to saying that you're from Massachusetts. Wait.
Boston's in Massachusetts.
Yeah.
It? Yeah.
That's equivalent
to saying... That's like saying I'm from Boston, and then, like, I go to college somewhere, and people are like, oh, dude, you're from Boston? Like...
Yeah.
For people that are, like, closer, like, to like, New York.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, oh, exactly.
Yeah, but nobody would say that, though.
Well, people, it's the equivalent, right? But, like, that's what people do to us, essentially, because, like, I don't know, it's just clout or something. I have no idea.
I guess
so. Those people are just fucking weirdos.
Resident Insecure. Sleeper? Yeah, they are.
Yeah. Well, they're just weirdo people.
Insecurities.
Normal humans in real life don't judge on where you're fucking from.
That's what I'm saying, in real life, right? If this was in real life, the shorty would not be saying anything to me.
True, she'd probably be on her knees, straight up.
Okay, I don't know about that, but... Whoa.
Buddy, you have to flex sometimes. It's okay.
yikes.
But anyways, Erik, go off on what happened this week, brother.
So the shorty's shorty's always telling me to shut up. So the one time I shut up, or like, and she's always throwing out these, like, suck my dick jokes and all that. So I decided to be like, okay, I'm like, either shut up or suck me off.
Okay.
She got all defensive.
My man.
She's like, bro, you don't even know me like that. Back up and put some respect on my name. And then everyone in the chat's calling me goat. I'm getting goated by my chat. And then she's like, I don't know if you noticed, but I'm not comfortable with you. Therefore, my reaction is valid.
But, like, and then... it's just weird because, like, why would she say she's not comfortable with you? I mean, like, you guys don't even know each other IRL. It's literally just friggin' online school, right? So,
and then I don't know, and then she started crying about it. She made a whole separate group chat just to talk shit about me.
Did she actually? I didn't know this part. This is new.
She made a whole separate group chat just to talk shit about me. Oh my god, just because I made that one little joke. And I'm like, bro, if you can't handle a little lighthearted trash talk, don't even be talking at all.
That's right? True. I think that applies.
Don't be trash talking in the first place.
Exactly. I think if you want to trash talk people, you have to be able to take some heat, you know? Like, if I'm talking shit to Erik, like, oh, Erik, you're short or whatever, then he is within his right to be like, Vim, you're fat as hell. Like, shut up, you know? Like, you know?
Yeah, it goes both ways. And then Shorty's just crying about it, and then the other Shorty was backing her up, and, you know, it was just
call, a very... Call him fat, fuck it.
True.
Yo, wham.
That'll just get them all mad. Like, at that point, it's just like, hey, now it's just really just a free game. Anybody can say anything now.
But essentially, like, this girl has been riding Erik forever, and then, like, she's been throwing around jokes and stuff, and the one time he makes a joke, she's all like, "I'm not comfortable around you, you misogynistic pig."
What? So, yes.
You know, yeah.
That's not really a women thing, though. Like, there are so many guys that are the exact same way. Like, they won't say, "Oh, you're a fucking misandrist who hates men," or anything. But they will just be like, "Oh, that's not funny, bro. Fuck you, man. Square up, bro." Like, so many men.
No, you're right.
I've heard that, yeah. Yeah, I've heard that. Square up.
There's definitely snowflakes, but, like, in general, I feel like this has just been happening with, like, Ottawa women, dude. Like, I think Ottawa women are crazy. Dude, tell us the story
women about in general.
True. Tell us that story about that one girl you used to work with at the chocolate shop, the one that you tried to set me up with. She just started ghosting you out of nowhere and stuff.
Yo, the shorty ghosted me out of nowhere just because I stopped talking to her. And we worked together, and she just blocked me off of everything. Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, even Facebook. Just out of nowhere. For no reason. Like, shorties make no sense.
You stopped talking to her.
No, yo, like, I didn't. Kind of fast, though. Wait.
Shut up, man. Stop talking. It's over.
So you ghost her first, in theory.
No. I did ghost her. Like, I just don't text people in general.
Cope.
I just don't text people in general. I snap them. I'll snap her once in a while.
That's true.
But I don't just text people in general, because I don't like texting. It's boring. It's a waste of my time. I'm pretty sure, like, you guys can relate. I don't know.
No, I hate texting. I'd rather not text this big dude. If you just want to talk to me, either call me or just come over to my house.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you're gonna text him. Like, you're gonna text him weird shit.
Worst. Yeah.
Like, I'm gonna text weird shit, or you're gonna text weird shit, and neither of us are gonna know what's gonna happen. What each other are talking about.
True.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
So, sometimes I just say random things, and it happens. You know.
Yeah, and the shorty just cut me off out of nowhere, and then, boom. And hey, now, yeah. And yo, she showed up in my store the other day, right? She pulled up to the store the other day, and
really?
I was with my coworker, and she didn't say zip to me. Say zip to me at all.
Dang, what a pussy, bro. Dude. Anyways, yo, shout out to my homie, Adrian, in the chat. What's poppin', brother? Shout out to anyone who's watching this live. We respect you, and we love you.
Cherry.
Exactly.
Yes.
But anyways, Let's talk about double standards, okay? And we don't have to talk about women, right? Because, like, I'm gonna get banned if we talk about women too much. But damn it!
And now, don't choke on me too.
Take your time.
Bryce. Okay. Hey, Bryce.
One.
Hey, Bryce. Is your job, like, publicly known?
Publicly known. Depends on what you mean by that. If you mean, like,
are people familiar with
my friends know
your job? Yeah.
Oh. Yes. Yeah, they are. The only people that don't know are my parents, my sister, I think.
But they're never gonna see this, are they?
Oh, no. No.
Okay, yeah. Hell so no. For those who don't know, my good friend Bryce from Australia is he's an escort.
Hi.
So,
but here's the thing. When I was saying interesting, I was an escort, because now I'm heading back to Queensland, so I'm not being an escort anymore. Fuck that.
True. You can't be doing that in your mom's house. But, anyways, Bryce, let's hear some interesting stories from you, man. Like, you know, like, how do you pick up clients, dude?
How do I pick up clients? I quite literally look pretty in a fucking club. And sometimes, man, I'll literally just walk up to some groups of people, because I can tell that I will actually get along with them, because half the time they're wearing, like, streetwear, like me, and I'm like, hey, hi.
Wait.
Just because I don't care.
Wait, what? Wait, so you just go up to people in a club and they pay you?
No. I'll be talking to them initially. Man. No. I talk to people first.
Because you gotta, like, whine
and then it's just like, oh, hey, da 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 da. Yeah. But that's when I'm like, oh, yeah, I'll usually like sneakily like slide into the conversation. Oh yeah, by the way, I'm an escort. And then they go, and then like I become the center of the attention. And then it's like, oh, what's it like? What do you do? What's your prices? Just because they're like, oh, they're curious. But then there's always just that one person, who gets reeled in by it.
The one virgin.
Yeah.
No. Jeez.
A few, but no.
See, this is where,
hopefully majority of the time, no.
This is why I get surprised, because it's like if you're just chatting someone up in the club, like why wouldn't they just want to do it for free? Like, why would they want to pay you
That's why you have to think of it as a thing of, oh, what's the difference between me and someone else that they could like friggin' Jimbo?
Oh yeah, 12 inches
down the street.
That's the difference.
Jesus.
Well, no, because one's professional, one, well, quote unquote professional, because they don't know at the point you're professional. But like,
give me good money off that.
But it's that compared to like some guy they don't know that they're gonna have sex with versus some guy that they now it's like, okay, well, like I'm literally paying this guy to have sex with me.
Yeah, but not only that, but half the time what it starts out as is not, oh, let's fuck. What it is initially is, I'm quite literally rent a boyfriend. That's kind of that's what it is initially. $150 for an hour, and then, sorry.
That's you.
Yeah,
that's you. Yeah,
you had the four.
Oh wait, I thought you were gonna say something.
No, just
wait. I have a question. Oh, wait, question.
Erik has a question. Let's go.
How many STDs have you contracted?
Yeah.
Zero. I have gotten a bladder infection. Literally, last time was it? I literally got a bladder infection. I think a week before I went into quarantine, and I was just like, "Fuck you, fuck you," because I had to go to the doctors, and the doctor was like, "Oh, hi Bryce, how are you today?" And I'm like, "Oh yeah, I'm good." And she's like, "Do you need to be tested?" And I'm like, "I mean." Yeah, probably. And she's like, oh, why do you say that? And I'm like, well, I have a bladder infection. She's like, again? And I'm like, you really had to say that, didn't you?
Dang.
You really had to say that.
Well.
No, none currently. STIs, yes. But they've all healed and been completely fine.
Wait, so...
Because those something. Ones you can...
Do you, like, get paid extra to not use protection?
Yes.
Damn.
Wait, so, like...
off the books. Extra? And that's completely... That's completely determined by me. Like, that price is, well, more so determined by me. So if they're like...
Oh, so you analyze them and you're like, this bitch definitely has STDs, and you jack up the price a lot.
You don't jack it up, you tell...
Well, sometimes
I
quite literally
worth
it.
Yeah.
Actually, you want to know the most fucked up thing?
Yeah, go ahead.
Was a chick was like, oh, I'm into blood play, by the way.
What?
Oh,
and I was like...
Monka,
money is money, my man. Mm. Money is money.
But
no, I was like, also,
okay, let me put the knives away.
What I want to know is, Bryce, what was your demographic like? The average split between male and female and other, and then also like, what was your average income off of this?
Well, dude, he has to do taxes. Don't box his income, man.
You're right.
Like, God damn.
You're right. Did Bryce die? Hello?
Yeah, he did.
Hello?
Okay, so while Bryce is...
The blood play became real.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, bro.
Yeah.
Would you guys fuck your girlfriend on her blood?
No.
Real question.
On her what?
No. On her blood.
On her what?
On her period.
Blood. Oh. Yeah, probably. I mean, that's why the shower was invented, right?
Yo, on her crypts, blood.
On your crypts? Hey, yo. Yo.
Wait, did I? Set your weapon, bro?
Yeah, dude. For sure, man. Like,
okay.
Bro, like, I don't understand why people are afraid of that. Like, it's just a little bit of blood, man. Like,
no, it's not a little bit,
natural.
Bro.
It's a lot of it, bro.
It's just a lube, bro.
Bro, no. It's so much they have to exchange it after every day.
Oh, that is kind of a lot.
Like, it's so, like, it's like a sponge, bro.
Dude, but what if I had, like, oh, there he goes. What if I had, like, the water in the shower, no, just aimed.
No, and it like doesn't just... work like that. It doesn't work no. like that. No, no, it doesn't
Wouldn't
work like
that. Wouldn't the feel be weird, it's, though? Because, no. like, blood is way thicker and stickier and shit, yes. though. So, like, I don't know, maybe there's, like, a textural appeal to it. You know what it's I mean?
You know what? You guys have completely convinced me never to do this. And you know what?
I know.
Dude, you literally just have to wait a week. Like, literally just wait a week. Man.
My internet.
Bloody pussy be healed.
I don't know about you, but, hey, if I need to be dealt with... Motherfucker, I need to be dealt with, bro. Like,
okay, do it your fucking self.
Why would I use my hand, bro?
Just have her use her mouth instead.
Exactly. There you go. That's how it's supposed to be.
Huh? Bro.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, man. Hey.
Well, it's Bryce
anyways,
is
Bryce is back. So, brother, I had a question.
Oh, I want to ask. I want to ask him that. Oh, but you continue.
Yeah. So, while you were disconnecting, hello?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. So while you were disconnecting, I asked two questions. So I wanted to know, one, what was your demographic split like between like your customers? And then two, what was like your average like earnings?
Okay. Well, majority were guys. It was like 60-70% were guys, to be honest.
Dang.
And those ones, the age was I've had anywhere from fucking 18 to like a 50-year-old. I think the oldest was a 50.
I thought you said 15 for some reason.
Yikes, yikes, yikes. No, 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 no. Oh,
he was talking about a basement before, so.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Can't expose
that. In Australia, we don't have basements majority of the time.
Oh,
it's just not in our building. But, and then the chicks were usually like. There were half the time they just needed someone to talk to, or like they were depressed, or like they were.
Damn! What the fuck?
Yeah, yeah. So no, that makes sense. For the women's side, that was mostly rent a boyfriend for the women, but then it would progress to stuff. Man, but for guys, it usually half the time that was just straight, boom, let's go, boom, like straight into it. But,
yo, now that I think about it. Now that sorry, my bad. You go ahead.
Oh, I was gonna say, guys are just like, bro, I don't want to talk about my feelings, bro. I just want to fuck.
True.
Literally.
Dude, that is a double standard right there. Okay, for me, I want to talk about my feelings. Okay, I want to put everything on the table, man.
And then fuck.
And then exactly, exactly, brother. Hey, and if the river's running red, you better give me head.
Yo. You wait, Bryce.
Huh? Yes.
Would you fuck a girl on her bloods?
I have.
There you go.
Would
you
do it again? I wouldn't recommend it.
Shitty experience. How is that?
Why? Why would you recommend it?
I wouldn't recommend it.
Exactly.
First of all, hers was. It was browny red.
Oh, that means she's shitting, bro.
Oh. I accidentally signed up for a scat fetish, my guy. Sorry to tell you.
So that wasn't that great, but beyond that, it was pretty much fine. Just
does it feel different?
No, yeah, because I was wearing a condom. So at the end of the day, I wasn't really caring.
But I know guys that have done it. Muslim guys, yo, taking Muslim guys that would fuck their white girlfriend on their bloods.
Haram. No condom. That's haram. No, don't talk about that here.
I feel like Muslim guys are mad weird, so.
They are. To be fair, though.
Not all of them, obviously. But, like,
to be fair, they're, like, super, like, desperate. Like, let's be real here.
Some of them are mad. Some of them are mad weird.
Yeah. But, dude. So
I'm trying to convert guys, but.
After hearing, like, the success story of Bryce, like, this whole rent a boyfriend thing, like, dude, I low key want to try it. Like, do you know how much money I could make?
Sir, you don't even get girls from Tinder.
Yeah, see.
Alright, guys, that's the stream. I'm sorry. I'm out.
Early night for tonight, boys.
I'm joking. Vim gets matches on Tinder.
I get no checks, bro. I get nothing, man. Bro, let's Vim. Segue right into the double standards, dude. Why do the women want you to be 6 feet tall, have a car, have a job, be rich? And then look like frickin' Uniqua from the Backyardigans.
What? I don't think they know what you...
yeah. Okay, you guys need to Google what Uniqua from the Backyard Against looks like.
I'm not going to.
No,
but they look like that, you're saying?
I'm away fine.
He's saying that they look like that.
So look ugly.
Ugly alien fucking things, that's all.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
But,
Broom has been hit.
Yo, okay, so, like, yo, if...
I don't know. The same is true of men, though. Like, all the ugly men are like, I want a fucking 11 out of 10 bitch, big titties, big ass, perfect, you know. Cooks for me, home wife, fucking genius, you know. Wants to have a million kids with me.
To be honest, you know? I have yet to see a dude like that.
You haven't ever encountered
it. What do you mean? That's like every guy.
Sure.
No, I seriously have yet to seen that. Like, with all the dudes... No, like, let me explain. Like, all the dudes I know, like, whether they're good-looking or not, most of them just really... Like, they just want someone to chill with and, like, just, like, get to know and then, like, just share interests with, like, whether that's, like, anime or, like, Star Wars or cooking or whatever. Like, they just want to, like, build a friendship and then build, like, a relationship off of that. Whereas, like, I totally see where you guys are coming from, though. Like, there's probably 100% definitely, like, people out there that are like that, where, and that's where, like, the whole incel thing comes to play, where, like, they're literally just sitting at home, like, watching Pokimane stream or something and, like, wondering why they can't find, like, super beautiful girls or
yeah. Pokimane's not even that nice, though.
True.
No.
You guys are overrating Pokimane.
Fucking trash.
But, yeah, that's my two cents, man. Hey, you know me? I'm the CEO of misogyny, bro. I hate women.
Double standards,
hey,
bro.
Hey, at least you don't... Vimmy boy.
What's up,
hey, at least you don't get called... At least you don't get called by chicks, "Oh, you're so cute!" And I'm like, "Oh, thank you!" And they're like, "Oh, let's be friends!" And I'm like, "Why do you want to be friends?" And they're like, "Oh, you can be my gay best friend!" And I'm like,
"Yo,
fuck you!
Yo, I'd be brother zone front.
Fuck you.
Yo, I'd rather be brother zone than gay best friend zone, eh?
Yeah, I was like, you have no idea how many times I've been like getting the hots for a chick, and then she's just been like, "Oh, let's be gay. You can be my gay best friend. I'll take you out to like this and that." And I'm just like sitting there vibing, just like smiling, and just on the inside,
you're dying.
I just feel death.
Dude, I don't know what to tell you, brother.
Wait, what the, if you're the gay best friend, then it's just like, "Oh, come over," and then you go over, and then it's like, then he gets like, she's like, "Oh, like hold on, like let me change real quick, like let me
see."
Like,
that's
oh,
only worked out once in my life.
Easy wins.
Yeah, that's only worked once in my life. Never again.
Yo, who snapped in the chat?
What?
Yo, dude.
That's true.
Five gifted subs, yo.
Yo, who snapped?
Poggers.
Yo, Poggers.
I think that's one of the boys I got onto your stream.
Jeez.
Dude.
Shout out to the chat.
Legend, man.
Anonymous.
Shout out to the chat.
What an absolute legend, yo.
Yeah, definitely is.
Fucking Chad.
Oh, no, it's King Goofus.
Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for supporting me and the boys. We do this for you, man. But anyways, what were we talking about?
But yeah, if you can't handle trash talk, don't be trash talking at all. That's all I want to say.
Exactly.
Facts.
I thoroughly enjoy getting trash talked because half the time it ends up in like me and the other person just pissing ourselves laughing. Well, if we were already like relatively on good terms in the first place.
That's the best thing to do, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hundos.
Yeah. Hundo B, yeah.
What did you say, Hundo B? What the fuck is that?
I said Hundo P. Hundo P. 100%.
Welcome.
Keep it a 100.
To the Humble Bundle.
I keep it a $1.50 with you, brother.
Keep it a $1.50.
On a sack.
Oh, you can give me a $1.50. I don't care. Yeah, sure. Sure. I'll chuck in someone else on the side as well. Oh, no, I'm kidding.
Yikes. Bryce, if I'm paying for you, I'm only paying a $1.50, brother. I'm not paying anything other. And well, that's what we call the homie discount.
Yeah, that's like $1.50.
$1.50.
You want to know what our thing is? It's literally no friends, no family, obviously. Makes sense.
Yep.
Fuck you.
Yo, I had this one shorty that used to work with me. She was engaged with her boyfriend. but like they were in an open relationship, so they would prey on other male or females to join them in threesomes.
Dude, yes. I know those types, man.
And so what's wrong with that?
That's fucking no, nothing's wrong with that. I'm just like saying, like, the shorty, but this is the wrong part. Like, at work, the shorty would just fill up my arms and shit. And be like, wow, you're so confident. You're so big. I'm like, chill, we're at work.
Right.
Yeah. And then she's also saying, like, oh, I don't go and fuck coworkers. But yet she's doing all that shit. And shorty's just sending me mixed signals. I'm like, okay, I want to smash, but I can't really do that right now, but...
True.
I've been creepily caressed before, and later, she was bro, just like, oh, what lovely skin, olive skin you have. I'm like, oh, why, are you gonna take it?
Would you guys fuck a coworker?
Yeah, hell yes. Yeah. Dude, there's fuck so yeah. many, there's Whoa, so many coworkers. Is that even a question? Hell yes, bro.
Dude, damn, I'm not even probably. Friends, I'm not even friends with people I work with.
What? So you wouldn't... How?
Me? I mean, I'm an escort. Because,
yeah, you don't have to be friends to smash, bro.
Okay. Well, I mean, like, no, I'm not even I'm not even gonna go hang out with people that I work with.
Adrian like, in the chat. Adrian's okay, saying that he wouldn't do it because he doesn't want an STD. I'm dead.
Yo, same.
Fair, honest.
I don't know what kind of coworkers you have, brother, but...
Like, you guys hang out with people you work with?
Like back when I was tight with them before our lockdown, yeah, we'd go out and we'd get drunk, get shit faced.
Oh, I remember.
I would never do that because it's like in my head, like, oh, dude, like we're at work, like this is like business, like we're all here to work. Like I'm not friends with, like I can have friendly with you guys, but it's like I'm not any of your guys' friend. Like I'm just here to make money, just like all you. Like
hey,
I'm just
guys,
here to hang out, hey. Chill, have fun, and then bro, I'm going home. Like I don't want to see you guys.
Hey man, none of you are my friends. I'm just here to make money, guys. Yeah. You guys aren't my friends. This is
that's
strictly
a good
business.
Mentality, though. That's a good
that's
mentality.
That's it. That's
but
it.
I was friends with you before this. If I'm friends with you and then you come to work, like I'm still friends with you.
Yeah.
True. I feel that. I think for me, at least, like, dude, a lot of these girls who I work with, bro, they all are like crushing on me. Like they all, like a bunch of them have followed me on Instagram out of nowhere, right? And they're all like following me like around and shit, and they're like coming and talking to me, and I'm just like, yo, you know
they're
what?
They're coming, yeah.
I'm not gonna lie. I actually appreciate this, you know, talking to a female. That's stimulating. That's stimulating, fam.
Him just out here flexing that he gets shorties.
I don't get any shorties, bro. Like, okay, let me tell you something. At least half of these are 100% brother carding me so they can ask me for a ride after work one day. I guarantee you, right? But at least one of them, I know for a fact, at least one of them, bro, on my mama, it's a pursual.
That's
I'm telling
big,
you right now.
The woman.
I'm going to be honest.
Yeah. No, go. It's not important.
No, I'm not going to talk now.
Oh my god. Okay, so no, I was just saying Adrian. Oh my god. I was just saying Adrian saying that Vim, you're Chad.
Thank you. Yo, hey, shout out everyone in the chat, bro.
Yeah,
we're reading.
That's all I was going to say.
Yo, we're reading the chat as we go, man. Like we're not ignoring any of you guys. If I see something interesting, I'm gonna definitely mention it, but, you know, hey, anyone listening on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, anything like that, you guys are missing out. You better be coming on Twitch, baby.
Dude, watch it live.
It's Sursky.
I was gonna say. Yeah. Shout out Evan, bro.
Shout out Evan.
Taking his time out to shout out Evan.
Shout out Evan, bro.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt, like, whatever's going on, but shout out Evan.
Continue.
Dude, honestly, at this point, dude, Evan's like the production manager, bro. Evan.
He's right there.
Yo, Evan, can I get a sound check? Yeah, dude, he's not here. I can't hear him, bro. He's not talking.
Yeah, hey, we gotta get Evan on the podcast one day.
No, I'm only yo. This guy, the only one in my class that will come out and support me. Gotta appreciate that.
Yo, so Evan's familiar with you know who.
Anyways, we digress from that. Anyways,
wait. Yeah, I just wanted to say, dude, you were talking about like, would you like fuck a or go out with a whatever you said, like a coworker?
Yeah.
It's funny because my friend that like I'm friends with like IRL. I was in Discord with him today, and he said that this girl that he works with that he thought she was like pretty hot, and like he would have like gone out with her. She asked for his number today, or no, jeez. she said no, she didn't ask for his number. She said, hey, like, can I give you my number?
Yo.
And, like that, and he was like, With
the voice crack in
there? No, he didn't do, he definitely didn't do voice crack. He's like a fucking Vim. You'd like him because he's a fucking like when I say he looks like a gorilla, bro, he's a gorilla. Like,
he's a giga
Chad. Bro, but, he's a fucking man. Dude, he does like he could probably bench like 3 plates, like not even kidding. Like he's fucking huge. But
those are my numbers, man.
Yeah, he was telling me that it's like, and like he's like a weirdo freak, like. So it's like,
is he into
blood like he's like, he like literally has like no problem picking up girls. Like he like literally could like he's been matching with girls on Tinder like in the last like month or two, and like he'll literally just I literally just text like, hey, want to come over like fuck right now, and then there's like yeah, and he's like, okay, I'll pick you up right now. And then it goes back every Friday without fail.
Every Friday.
Well, that's how you get your like two to three months, he's been doing that. And like, dude, he's a freak. He does it to people in real life. He's like, bro, he's like, I can't do that with this girl. He's like, I can't just be like, yo, fuck now? Question mark. I can't do that. He's like, I can't do it with her. He's like, she's like the kind of girl that's like, you would like date and shit. Not that you like, you just want to smash because she's pretty.
Hey, let me tell you something, brother.
Like, good personality and shit. And I'm like, oh shit. I'm like, what are you gonna do? He's like, I don't know. I'm like,
hey, let me tell you something, man. He's got to watch out because as soon as he makes the wrong move, she's gonna go right to the manager. He's gonna get fired. He's gonna get sued. He's not gonna be able to use it as a reference, bro. Man. She's gonna say that.
Oh no, he's like one of No. He's like the nicest person. Like a.
Oh okay.
A freak. Man. He's a freak and shit. And like he says like some like. Pretty like edgy things, but it's like he's honestly like one of the nicest people I know.
Oh, I was worried because you said he looked like an ape, so I assumed. Oh yeah,
me. No. He says he told me he goes in and like I know what he looks like. So it's like picture like this big ass dude, shaved head, beard, like walks into like the back room to where he works and he goes, oh what up guys, like how's everyone doing guys, hey guys, like. He's like, oh yeah, he's like, I walk in the back and I'm like, ooh, like kawaii senpai, ooh woo, hi guys. Like he's like, I didn't actually say that, but he's like, that's literally me. He's like, I go in and I'm like acting all like cute and shit. I'm like, bro, like you're just a fucking like massive man. Like he literally looks scary. Like people stare at him, he's that big.
I can't imagine. That's hilarious.
That's Vim right there.
Yeah. I'm not bald though.
Bro, he just has he's not bald. He has a shaved head.
It's like like if me and Pierre did the whole Dragon Ball Z power combining thing, dude.
True.
Yo, you guys should do it right now.
Yeah, Vim, I'll send.
Oh my
god. Wrong way. Pierre, wrong way.
Other way.
Yeah.
There you go.
Other way.
Huh? Other way. No, Vim, you have to go the other way.
Holy shit.
No, I'm on the right way on the screen.
No, on my screen it's this way.
Oh, bruh.
No, I'm watching the stream right now. I'm in the right way.
Yeah, the stream. It's the right way. It was the right way from the stream.
Right. Oh, whatever. We did it.
Okay, whatever. It doesn't matter. We did it in our own mind. Okay. I'll send you a picture of him after this. So it's like the story. It even makes it even better if you see it.
True.
But yeah, true, that's like the dating coworker. So we'll see how it we'll see how that one turns out. I'll let you guys know if it works out good.
Dude, okay, so somebody just sent me a DM, and
just now,
they want me to ask this question on the podcast. Mm-hmm. So they're asking, has anybody ever been in a situation where a girl would constantly string you around and keep you as the quote unquote second option? So she'd use you for like emotional, like support and connection, and there's obviously something there. But then whenever you try to pull the trigger, it's like, no, I'm sorry, like I don't really want to do this right now, I'm not too sure. And then, you know, next thing you know, they're like into this other guy, but they keep stringing you along, you know what I mean?
No,
personally, no, but I know people, I know shorties that do that.
All right, so Bryce actually doxed one of his girls, but Bryce, go ahead.
Well, it's fine. Well, do you remember I remember Vim got to see the chick freaking on the stream once. She was at my place just like said hi on the stream but anyway, that was basically what happened with me. It was initially, oh, she was like, oh, you're cute, and then I was like, oh, thanks, and long story short, we got along, but then it just slowly progressed into I just became the fuckable friend, and then second of all, she was actually going, still going out to like clubs and shit, and she would deliberately not invite me to ones where she was like actively looking for a guy. Like I saw on her Instagram where she was like, was it she suddenly just started hanging out with one guy constantly, and I'm like, I wonder. And then eventually, not long after, she was like, oh, we're now dating.
That's a yikes for me.
And I'm just like,
that's cringe.
And I'm just like, yeah, well, that is cringe. I'm glad we haven't done anything in a while.
That's a yikes for me, man. I don't know what to tell you.
IFM.
For me, at least, like, I did have this kind of thing. Hey, Brad in the chat. Brad, what's poppin', brother? Hope you're doing well. Miss you.
Brady.
And, hope you enjoy your stay. But, for me at least, okay, so the setting is high school, right? So I think I'm in grade 11 at this point, so I'm like, what, 16 17, and I had this friend, all right, and she and I were very close. We're still actually very close, and we still talk every now and then. But I had this friend, and she was seeing this dude, but the dude ended up moving away, and they ended up breaking up, so she was all brokenhearted and stuff. And like throughout this entire time, I definitely had feelings for her, but yeah. I just wanted to be like friends because I cared about like just like the relationship that we had, where it's like we can be completely open with each other and like it's not weird, right? So after a while, she starts like teasing me with like explicit things, and I'm just like, it's kind of weird, but I kind of like it. So she strings me on along for a while, and like at this point, I'm starting to wisen up, bro. Like Squad W is like flowing through my veins, and I'm just like, wait a second. She keeps talking the talk, but she won't walk the walk. So I tried pulling the trigger one day, and then like the next, like she was actually my first kiss. So like, you know, hey, that's a different story. But let me tell you, man, December 31st. 2015? No, 2014. December 31st, bro. New Year's Eve, bro. Pull the trigger.
Why the fuck do you know that?
Why would you?
I just remember I just kissed a chick in a fucking bush. What the fuck, dude?
Come on, man. And that was bush. Like,
it's your story.
Well, most
your story.
Okay. First kisses are actually special.
Anyways, so
sorry.
It was pretty special to me, okay? But anyways. Over the next couple days, like, we don't talk as much. I don't know why. And then she just tells me, like, hey, I don't really want to do this anymore. And then I was like, so you were just using me as a rebound? And she was just like, yeah. And then that was it, bro. Like, I, at that point, I became the biggest, like, incel ever. I was like, shut up, woman. And, like, I just, like, I could.
Dang.
And, yeah.
Hated women ever since.
Ever since then.
I mean.
But no, I'm kidding. I didn't say like shut up woman and stuff like that. But no, that actually broke me, dude. It absolutely broke me. Cause like I was like thinking about like spending the rest of my life with this girl, and like it actually.
And back in high school?
Back in high school, yeah. Absolutely
broke me. Hey, we all had dreams.
And
Yo, high school. Oh man, high school. Anyways, continue.
But yo, wait, what's your homie's name in the chat? Eddie or Ede or what?
Evan?
Yeah. All right, my bad. Evan, it wasn't just flirting, because like we were definitely like in a relationship, like a form of a relationship. Like we weren't dating, like we didn't have labels, but like it was at the point where it's like we were definitely like planning to start dating, right? And like she was the one, like she was essentially grooming me, bro, because at this point I didn't even know anything about women or like anything at all. Like I'm talking like I didn't even know where the PP went, bro, right? And so she was like, she was grooming me, bro. Like I was very innocent, bro. I had a very innocent upbringing, so I did not know these things at all.
Damn.
And
a straight loser,
dude, let me tell you, man. Okay,
bro.
So I am a straight loser, but
not right now,
but you know. But anyways, so after like a year of not talking, she ends up apologizing and we make up and stuff, right? And so my birthday's coming up, and coincidentally my birthday is on the day of prom, right? So all the seniors got the day off and we got to like stay home to do our makeup and stuff like that. Like I don't know anything about that, bro. I didn't even do my hair, right? So then she's like, since we have the day off, why don't you come over for a surprise?
Yo, like, surprise, the slumber party.
I'm like, yo, let's go, dude. Right? So I pull up. All right. And she comes, like, she invites me in. And then she's like, do you want to play some Wii? And I'm like, I know you're going to be playing with joysticks sometime throughout the day, so let's do it. Right?
Oh, no.
Damn, this is just like, yo, let me beat your ass in, like, Wii Sports.
Anyways, we're playing Wii. Next thing, like, and, like, her, she's saying her stomach was bothering her, like, throughout the day. Next thing you know, like, she goes to the bathroom. She comes back and is like, yeah, I'm sorry. It's that time of the month.
Damn.
Ruff, oh my god.
On my birthday, on my 18th birthday, and on prom day. And I was just like, you know what? That's fine. Right?
Damn, she lied about it for sure. She lied.
I just went home.
Sex to give up moment, to be
honestly,
honest.
Yeah.
I definitely
doubted the legitimacy of the Red River at that point. But I was just like, you know what? It's fine. And I went home and I was sad. I didn't even have anyone to go to prom with. Like, this one girl I wanted to ask, I didn't get to ask her, but I asked this one dude. I'm like, yo, do you think I should do it? And he was like,
yes,
nah.
Yes, to do the prom.
Yeah, no, the dude, what the fuck, Eric? No, the dude was like, nah, like, she's probably not going to go with anyone. Next thing you know, I pull up to prom and this guy's like there with that girl. Like, he asked her to prom and I'm like, oh my god.
That's tough. That's tough.
Wow.
Man's life is a Disney movie. True, dude. Yo, my life can really be a movie. Like, I'm telling you, like, I got bare stuff to talk about, man. My life really is a movie.
Yo, did anyone go with someone to prom? Did you guys have prom?
Yeah, we had, I had prom. I didn't go to either my prom.
My man. Either.
You had more than one.
Oh, yeah, it was junior year you had it, but then senior year you could go, like, if you wanted. Oh, okay. Like, the juniors hosted prom, but then the seniors, like, could just go if they wanted to. Mm. I didn't go to either because I didn't give a shit, to be honest. Yeah. I just went to, I hung out with people afterwards. I went to the after parties and
The after parties chilled. Where was that, yeah.
Ayo, shout out Adrian. Shout out Adrian in the chat, bro. He was able to dance with his crush at prom. Dude, that's goals.
Poggers.
That's goals.
Chad.
Poggers. Absolute Chad.
I danced with some random white chicks.
Eric with a white girl? What? What is this blasphemy?
Yo, I didn't dislike white people back in high school.
True, true, true. Okay, for those who don't know, Eric and white people.
Come on, man. Okay, listen. Okay, listen. It's like when women say men are trash, they don't mean individual men, they mean like
all men
as a whole, right?
True.
But for me, when I say white people, I mean white people as a whole, but individually, I know some sick white people. I have three in I'm talking to right now, you know?
Fuck. Yeah, that's okay. It's kind of double standard there, eh?
But what if I could say the other way? What if I was to say black people on the whole are trash, but some individuals are cool? Would that be fine, my man?
That's fine. You can say you can say that you hate niggers, and I'd be okay with that.
Bye, Vim.
Wait, okay.
Did I just get the pause?
Hold on. That was used in a contextualized educational sense. Yeah. Okay?
No, it was
for educational purposes.
That was an educational purpose because, let's be real, in To Kill a Mockingbird, they use the N-word a bunch, right, when talking about black people, right? And so in this situation, given, it's meant to say that, like, X person absolutely hates black people. Please do not report me. I don't want to get banned.
If you're just listening to this and not watching and wondering why it's bleeped, that you know the reason why now.
It's probably not going to be bleeped.
It's not going to be bleeped, bro. Eric keeps saying that he'll edit the audio,
edit it
and he never
out,
does.
Eric.
Okay, I'll have to edit it out.
Bleep the
I can say it. Listen, I can say the word because I am myself a...
Bleep.
Yeah,
there you go. Hey, my...
You're pausing so you don't have to edit it out.
Yeah, hey, exactly.
Yeah, it's
I'm both sand and...
Oh,
both,
my God.
Yeah, okay? Just...
Dude, why do we divulge? Why is this... Why is...
We want to talk about, dissecting,
like,
this.
Even this one is supposed to be about, like, misogyny in women.
Yeah.
Like, Eric ends up just, like, Eric ends up making it, ends up saying it somehow. Rip. It's happened like it's happened 3 weeks in a row. I'm not even gonna lie.
It happened once.
No, this is like four times.
It happened last week, and I'm pretty sure it happened the week before. I'm not gonna lie.
It did.
In like three different contexts.
It's okay. Are you guys uncomfortable?
No, I just think it's funny.
I think it's funny. Like, I think it's funny that you just didn't care.
No, I don't care. Yo, you see, guys, I don't care. My life is a joke. No. I'm a joke.
Same. Dude, hey, clowns make 51K a year, and we're out here doing it for free.
Exactly.
Yeah, true. Well, no, five gets its subs, not free anymore.
Yeah, that's facts. We're at seven out of 20.
7 out of 20, dude. Hey, if I can hit 20 subs come the end of the month, hey, that's a win. That's a win.
Poggers.
Evan, drop your Twitch, Amazon Prime sub.
Twitch Amazon Prime.
There's 2 days. Yeah.
There's 2 days? Oh, crap. Damn, we lost.
What do you mean hit fucking 20 subs by the end of the month, bro?
Oh, dude, I forgot it. I forgot it was like 2 days from the end of the month.
I'm about to drop 20 subs on myself, man. Like, what?
Jesus.
Oh my god.
Let's get back on topic, dude.
Let's diss some women. Anybody got any sus stories about women? I shared mine from high school.
Nah. We kind of took it as a joke. Like, we kept saying like a kid we knew, like that we'd friends with, like down the hall from our dorm, like when I was in college or university, uni for the AU people here.
And Canadian. Yes, sir.
Yeah, just making sure you guys know what I'm talking about. Yeah, down the hall, he was like, we were friends with him. And, like, this girl, like, we think she, like, technically raped him, like, twice.
What?
Twice?
Yeah, two different occasions.
What?
Bro.
Yeah.
Detail.
Where, like, he went home with her, and then he woke up, and he's just like, why are you here?
Why are you here?
Yeah, she's like, what do you mean? She's just like... He's like, I don't remember anything that happened. I blacked out. Like, why are you here? Like, I don't understand why you are here. Like, leave now.
Oh, like, pussy like, is just so good. It gave
and
you
like
break,
we know, and like we
guy.
And like we know. Well, he was blacking out on his own accord, anyways. But then she was like benefiting off of it on purpose because she wasn't drunk. She was pretending.
Oh my god! And we knew she was pretending. Bro, I absolutely, like, the one thing I hate is, like...
But then after that week, there's, like, we noticed, and we were, like, oh, shit. Like, the first time, we were, like, oh, damn, and he was, like, bro, I didn't remember shit. And then the second time it happened, we were, like, oh, this is, like, fucked up. And then, she didn't. He was...
Oh, okay.
He was getting blasted on his own. That was, like, on his own time. He was gonna do it anyways, and then, like, she just took advantage of it. Like, she didn't, like, do anything to, like, roof him or, like, get him anything. Yeah, so then after that, we were, like, anytime we saw them, we were, like, hey, bro, remember last time? And he's, like, yeah.
Yo, shout out Evan for using that Prime sub, dude. Yes, shout out yes, Evan. Let's go, Evan, dude. Oh my god. Big up.
Oy.
But what I was gonna say is the one thing I hate is like when the whole group is getting sauced or like a bunch of friends are getting sauced, and then there's always that one person who's either pretending to be sauced or like acting up or like just not getting sauced at all, and then they're like trying to take advantage. Like, dude, my ex-girlfriend once tried to do that to me in first year. It was like the first night I ever got sauced, and like we were on rocky terms, and I was trying to stay away from her, and like she just kept like following me, bro. Like, I have pictures on my Snapchat, and like she just kept following me around, and I'm just like, yo, like, leave me alone, like I'll be fine, like I'm with my homies, right? And like she just kept following me around, and then like obviously nothing happened, but you know, thank god, dude. Like I absolutely hate women who think they can get away with like sexual assault and shit, you know what I mean?
Well, I mean, guys
they kind of can,
though. Well, no. Obviously, guys do it. Like, No. Like, you're misunderstanding. Obviously, guys do it, too. And, like, I just feel like if, like, obviously, like, guys, when they do it, they deserve to be jailed. They deserve to be, like, in my opinion, chemically castrated and stuff, right? But, like, all the girls that go after the dudes who, like, commit sexual assault, they literally do nothing when a girl commits sexual assault because they're all like, oh, guys are bigger, they should be able to fight back or whatever. But it's like, that's not the case for everything, you know? Like if a dude got sexually assaulted, you gotta take that seriously, like, no matter who the perpetrator was, right?
Okay.
I am 55 kg.
Okay, let me...
Is that light? 125 pounds.
Yeah, that's pretty light. But anyways, like Pierre, go ahead.
Oh, wait, I was gonna say, this same
you're
girl, like,
just
when
wait,
we were
just
at...
Just wait,
like,
please.
Hold up, Pierre,
you're 55? Aren't you like 6 foot one or something, Bryce? Holy fuck!
6 foot, 183 centimeters. Yeah.
Isn't that like emaciated? My guy, are you starving?
Senor underscore two says, "Tell Klaus his cock is small." Heart. Anyways, much love.
Have oh, bro.
Hey, true love you, brother. But
oh my goodness, I'm quitting the stream, bro. I'm done. Call it a day, bro. Honestly, you think you know somebody?
Oh shit! Pierre, they're asking for my food order. Pierre, one sec.
Where's Pierre? Hello.
Yeah, Pierre, what were you saying?
I don't know. I forgot what I was gonna say. Oh yeah, I was gonna say that. Yeah, the same girl who like supposedly like did whatever with like one of my friends. Like she walk around like grab guys' dicks, just like.
Whoa, that's whoa, assault, whoa.
Yeah.
Well,
walk her like, up. She was on like some sicko mode shit. Like,
I think
her
like,
up. Like yeah. she was going hard.
There definitely was a time where like that was considered like a turn on or acceptable. But like,
No. But she like grabbed my dick and I'm like, you fucking touch me again, and see what the fuck happens. And she was like,
no way, no.
She was like,
way.
That's what I'm talking about. She was just like, yes sir. Like tips fedora. Yes, my good sir.
My man,
because I already knew, like, I knew her, so I was like, yeah, like, fucking try me, bitch, like, pretty much. Okay. And she like she already knew like what the fuck I was on, like I literally she would like try to like do her like seduction thing, and I'm like, yo, you can get the fuck off me now, or like, I'm literally like, I'm not gonna knock her out, but it's like, you know what I mean, like, I'm just, like,
yeah, yeah,
like, I'm just like, bitch, like, you can't do that. You can't, like, no one can seduce me, like, this is literally impossible, like, I have no emotions, fucking try me. I shut down women, like, you don't, like, that's you have facts, no you have no rule over know. Me
that's
you
facts.
Like no- that happened to me. I got my dick and balls grabbed by a chick when I was in school.
Yeah,
was it consensual?
And like, no,
I know the feeling.
That's assault, brother.
Was it hot?
But yeah, I was just stunned. I'm gonna be honest, I wasn't even shocked or anything. Like, I wasn't even like, God, this is horrible. I was just like, what the fuck are you doing, bitch? You know, I was just honest. In awe at, like, the sheer fucking wackiness.
Audacity.
You know
what
I mean? I was in awe that it was her, but if it was somebody, like, I was attracted to, I was like, I'm gonna be honest, she had a pretty firm grip, I'm not gonna lie. Like, it was, it was a pretty good grab. Like, if I was attracted to her, she would have got me. I'm gonna be honest with you guys.
Okay, we appreciate the transparency.
Exactly. Hey, yes. Firm grip, brother. That's what I'm talking about.
Well, no, but yeah, she caught me off guard because I saw her walking up, and then she hit me with it, and I was like, yo, who the fuck?
Oh, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I mean, at first, I was like, yo, who the fuck just touched me?
Yeah.
And then I saw her, and I was like, oh, fucking you. Goddamn, get out of my sight, witch.
You want to know the worst part? If I was more, like, older, maybe, like, more, like, mature, you know? Because this bitch was hot. The bitch that did it to me, she was hot. If I was more interested in girls, I totally would have been like, yeah, I'm down. You know what I mean?
But you're not interested in girls?
I missed out, bro. Fucking hell.
He was immature.
Yeah, he was immature. So,
back then.
He didn't know.
Past tense.
Yeah. Honestly, I'm not going to lie. If a girl did that to me, I'd probably be like, I'd probably knock her out straight up. I wouldn't even give her a warning. I'd just be like, what are you doing, bro?
That's a case.
That's not a case. That's she touched case. Me.
Yeah.
But
squad W, baby. Yeah, that's
a double standard. Cool. Can't really
prove
that way,
buddy. What do you mean?
She can be like, what do you mean? I was just walking by you.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, we take my pants and we put them into a vacuum sealed bag and we get it analyzed for the DNA.
For fingerprints.
Exactly. Yeah. Dust that shit.
I gotta dust the white stuff on your dick, on your balls.
All right, brother.
Sorry, I just okay, dude. Just, when they like wiping the powder off, all you just see is like a cock and bull.
that's
the fingerprint.
They dust the stuff on. They dust the stuff on, and then it's like clear it off to see the fingerprint. They go, and it's just like little comes off the tip, and you just see a nice fingerprint right there.
Okay, dude. No, I guess. Well, that if it came to that, like, it would depend on where it is, right? Like, if it's at work, there's definitely cameras there, right?
Hmm. Oh, yeah.
Okay. But if it was out in public, I'd probably just run away. Like, turn into the same bolt.
Oh, we have it. Oh, it was at, like, a house party, though.
Oh. Okay.
It was in an environment where it was, like, it could have been seen as, like, flirtatious, but it was just, like, bitch, like, get the fuck off me.
Oh yeah.
True. Like, she's grabbed multiple. She was a known dick grabber. She's a serial dick grabber.
A serial dick grabber.
Yeah.
Wow.
We had one of those.
Are you good? You freeze?
No, I'm good. I just got a DM saying that Nate Robinson lost.
No way.
Who's that?
What do you mean?
Yeah, I know what that means for sure.
Like Nate Robinson versus Jake Paul?
Yeah.
You guys know what that is or no?
Is that like some like...
No.
It's like
so everyone knows who Jake Paul is, but like Nate Robinson, used to be a basketball player.
Right? They went down. I didn't know they were fighting today.
Yeah, they're the undercard for Fury and Jones.
For who?
Mike Tyson and...
Hello?
Damn, you hate to see it.
I think I froze up for a second, but anyways, I'm gonna quickly Google the legitimacy of what happened, but...
Well, he does this, so...
Yeah, he lost, damn.
Oh, Nate Robinson actually lost?
Yep, he lost.
What a cock, dude!
You hate to see it.
Trash, man. Alright, Adrian says, yo, I gotta go now, sorry I can't stay on longer, hope you guys have a good night, peace, and talk to you guys later. Yo, brother, thank you so much for coming and watching
shout
live.
Shout out to... Yeah, shout exactly. out to reaching.
You can definitely catch the rest of this when it's uploaded to Spotify. If you want to see our ugly faces, check it out on YouTube. But we'll see you later.
Anyways,
women. I hate them.
Y'all ever been called out? Wait. Bryce?
Hi. Yes.
Are you... What is your sexual orientation? What do you consider yourself as?
My conception is... my thought process is, if there's a hole, there is a way, and as long as it's not my hole, I'm happy.
Fair.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if what I'm about to say will offend you or not.
No.
Okay, anyway, so one time I got called out by this Bati boy. catcalled by this Bati boy, and yo, I went up to his whip, and
So for those who don't know, a Bati boy is a gay person.
A gay person, sorry.
You could just said I got catcalled by a gay dude.
Nah, but this is a Toronto podcast.
I have to put the Toronto... Yeah,
no wonder why people hate Toronto.
True.
I'm with Pierre, fuck Toronto, to be honest.
I can literally see why, okay.
Dude, it's EU slang. It's actually EU slang. Like, Bati boy is...
And still hate it. Trash, get out of here, dog. Talk normally, god damn.
But anyway, what about us with fucking thong,
Yeah, but we're fucking cool. I don't give a shit.
True. But, anyway, some bias what were you trying to say, Erik?
Oh, so I went up to his whip, because we were crossing the I went up to his whip and, like, say that to my face? This guy screwed it off. But I was looking, like, I know we're bashing women here, so I just want to bring some light to us bashing women. So I know how it feels catcalled, and it's not a great feeling.
Hey, boys, look who's in the chat, Mr. Scintillating GG. Y'all like them pickles. Hey, what's poppin', brother? Anyways, let's get back onto topic. We just talked about the Bati boy dumbs, but
wait.
Yeah.
I'm confused, though. Erik, couldn't you just been like, yo, I'm not gay, but like, thank you, I know I'll be looking good today.
I could have said that, but I was looking embarrassed.
It catches you off guard.
Yeah, it catches you on guard. Off guard, yeah.
I find it embarrassed.
I've said that before.
Yo, actually, I'm just coming on to this. Like,
no, but
it's
you're
like,
straight, Pierre.
It's like a realization, dude. Like, I'm just realizing, like, yo, every time a gay person hit on me, like, they're giving me a compliment. I should be thanking them.
You should be, yeah, I guess.
Even if a girl hits on me, I'm just like, damn, like, I'm straight, but like, I know it'd be looking good. Like, now fuck out my face. I'm trying to work.
Sorry, continue.
Friggin' oh my god, wait. Oh god, what's your name? Yeah. Oh no, the
Pierre.
You and I have such totally different thought processes. You're just like, yeah, get out of my face, and I'm just like, hey, hi, here's my present. Like, I'll just, like, chat someone up no matter what. Like, oh my god. Our thought process is so different. Holy shit.
Fuck that. What a waste of time. Most people are so boring and cringe. Fuck that. Get out of my face.
Oh, no, true.
If someone's coming up to me and being like, oh my god, I like how you look. Like, can I get your number? I'm just like, I don't know, bro.
Yo,
like,
Aiden, why are you chilling in chat, bro? Just pull up onto the show.
Resident sleeper on that one, bro.
Yeah, I'm like resident sleepering people who are like, oh my god, can I have your number? It's like, bitch, like, I'm at work, brother. Like, this is fucking weird.
Yo.
Like, buy shit and leave.
Dude, friggin', what was I gonna say? So there's this lady at work, right? And I work at a retirement home. And this lady should just move into the retirement home. That's how old she is, right? And she's one of the cooks. So the other day, one of my coworkers, he comes back and he's like, Vim, can you please take this back to the cook? And I'm like, why? And he's like, the resident said that the liver was like too hard, and the other food that she made was it tastes like shit. And I'm like, bro, why are you telling me? Like I don't know what to do. And he's just like, I don't want to go and tell her, because like she has like this worst attitude ever, where she's like, I'm right, you're wrong, customers are wrong, my food is good, right? So he goes back with the dishes and he's like, Vicky, there's something wrong with the food. Like, the customers or the residents don't like it. Who just joined?
Wait, who joined?
Oh, shit. Oh, man. Yeah.
He came in, I came out. Trying to
cut.
Bro.
Fake blue friends, board. Man. What blue can board. I say? I'm kidding.
Honestly.
But, so the cook straight up took the liver. She cut out a piece and she ate it. And she's like, oh, that's fine. I don't know why they're complaining. And then, like, she proceeded to give him a lesson about how food works and about how when a liver is being cooked, how it, like, chemically cooks and stuff. Instead of just making a new one, she starts giving him a lesson. And then she just, like, sent back the food, like, to the resident. Just like, here, just eat it. And, like, I was like, yo, if I did that, I would have gotten fired, dude. Like, holy shit.
Oh, yeah. I don't do that shit. That shit's fucking whack.
Yeah.
Duh.
Oh, my God. Yo, Klaus, that's hilarious. Shout out to Aiden for coming out tonight. I know it was short, but much appreciated.
Facts, dude. Aiden, it was good to, dude, it was good to see you on. A special guest just, like, coming on. Dude, super special guest, Aiden. We love to see it.
Dude, Aiden, brother, I didn't get to tell you because you were only on for so short, but hey, I miss you, brother. I love you, dog. Straight up. Mind you.
Next time, come on, maybe a little cute,
my guy. Yeah, next time, hopefully you can stay on a little bit longer and talk about double standards. But
yeah, we'll see you next week.
Facts.
But anyways, let's get into the meat.
Yeah. What's the topic you
meat want? Of tonight? Yeah, the meat and potatoes of tonight. Yep. Right? So, who here is unfamiliar with the recent drama that happened with popular Twitch streamer and queen Pokimane?
I am.
Eric's hand is up.
So, Eric, so essentially there's this one streamer, Pokimane. She's essentially like the female face of Twitch. Pretty much untouchable. Yep. And
well, yeah, I know that. Yeah.
Right, okay. So she's had a few run-ins where she's come off as like a ruthless businesswoman, copy-striking people's videos and like complaining about this person's no longer following me and stuff like that. And so a couple months ago, there was this drama where this one person in her house...
drama, this was real life.
Situation. Okay, yeah, it was a real...
That's can't really my bad. Call it drama.
That's my bad. So this one person that she lived with and was friends with, named Fedmeister, he was accused of sexually assaulting two of his roommates, two females. And essentially what came to light was that he had kissed one of their hands and like touched like the side of her body, like nothing like sexual, like just touched her body. And then he got some bad vibes and he left. And then apparently he did it again, and he was saying that, oh, I was drunk and stuff like that. And then he also did the same thing to another girl that lived in the house, so two girls. Everybody finds out, and then they kick him out of the organization, Offline TV, and like he moves out of the house and everything. And yeah. Pokimane made a video where she was calling him out for a lot of stuff. And then one of his best friends, Yasuo, who's another streamer, also made a video calling him out about certain things. And so Pokimane was saying that they never dated, they were just friends, and that he was manipulating everybody behind the scenes, trying to get people kicked out. And so it wasn't him who did it, but a couple days ago, a document was leaked, a 25-page document, where Fed includes texts and context to the entire relationship between him and Pokimane, just calling out so much bullshit from her video. Because in her video, she stated, we're just friends, and that was the extent of our relationship. But Fed drops bare DMs, fam. And in these DMs, Poki is literally sexting this guy. She is telling him to come over, have a sleepover, all sorts of shit where it's like, dude, they're definitely either dating or they're about to date. And like, she's said in the text like multiple times that she wants a date, but she doesn't know. She wants a date, she doesn't know. And you can see the timestamps for the dates, and like everything she said in her initial video was just straight up contradicted by those texts. Like, this was a good document. I loved it. Like, I think it was really detailed. And then she came out with her own stream, and she was trying to disprove his points. And literally all she did was she would be like, oh, these are cringy, I'm not going to read them. She laughed a bit, she deflected, and that was the end of that video.
Well, like, she didn't laugh a bit, she laughed at all of it.
But yeah, she essentially like, I was trying to sound a bit nice, but she laughed at a lot of it. And so the drama right now is that Pokimane's coming off as a very, very manipulative person, because turns out Fed wasn't the person who wanted to kick anybody out of the house. It was Poki, because, and I quote, that person was unproductive or whatever. So, dun, dun, dun. So a lot of stuff, essentially, from my point of view, what I can tell is that she, like, they were getting rid of Fed regardless. So her goal was, let's dump all this other stuff onto him. Nobody needs to know. And that'll be the end of it. And the thing is, Fed, he made this document to send to his friends to try and gain some of his reputation back, because Poki painted him in a really bad light. And the DM got leaked by one of his friends, right? Or not the DM, sorry, the document. And Fed released a statement saying, hey guys, it wasn't supposed to be leaked at all, and I'm sorry for that happening. But in that statement he put out, it says explicitly that Pokimane told me not to drop this document, and that when I returned to Twitch, she would just give me her support and we would go our separate ways. So that tells me that Poki saw this document and she was like, if this gets out, I am screwed, and told him, do not upload it. So even after all of this, she's still manipulating my man.
You hate to see it. You hate to see it.
But that's like, that's essentially what happened. So since you don't know too much about it, we'll just move on to the next person. So Pierre, my guy, what is your opinion on this?
To be honest, it's like really like means nothing. It's just like some inner, like, it's like some, dude, it's just like real life people shit.
True.
Literally happens to like people that like I know.
Or just, exactly.
Like, you text like a bunch of people being like, hey, like da da da, and then like one of your friends like texts it to the person like it's about, and then that person's just like, yo, why the fuck did you text me? Except it's just on like a bigger scale, and like people like act like they care, but it's like this doesn't even affect like sponsor deals. Like,
yeah,
sponsors are gonna look at her and be like, ooh, is she gonna manipulate our product? Like, she's like, dude, like, who gives a fuck, bro? Like, those are just like dumbass business people. Like, they don't give a fuck.
No, I think like I don't care so much about the whole like love triangle or whatever, or I don't care about like, oh, DMs got leaked. Like, DMs get leaked all the time. Like, remember Mitch Jones' DMs got leaked, and like they did the whole detective thing.
Partnered for it though.
Okay, well, no, nobody's like unpartnering Pokimane, right?
Like, Mitch Jones isn't partnered anymore. That's kind of like a bigger league. I mean, losing partnership is like you're losing revenue.
Oh, that's true. But okay, Twitch is never gonna unpartner Pokimane. That's on God. But
that's not true.
Well, they fucked up.
Banned XQC for 7 days.
Yeah. Okay, no,
but their biggest.
It's like their top three biggest streamer.
So, let me rephrase. They're not going to ban Poki over this.
He's also a man.
Forsen's indefinitely banned.
Why was that again? And DMCA, right?
Somebody sent an imager link, and he clicked on it, and he went to refresh the imager, and you should never refresh an imager, because you can update the imager link to something else. And what it updated to was a naked girl sucking a horse's dick.
Beautiful. Oh.
And he showed it on stream for like literally 2 seconds, like max. And then Mitch it over and was like, oh, right. He's like, that's why I never hit refresh, because he knows that people are going to do that. and he got banned indefinitely for it.
Aiden says he's seen that video.
That's a fucking bad reason, though. People in the community are bad, so you should get banned for it. Fuck that.
See, like,
he's been banned a bunch of times before, but like people literally like I'm pretty sure Pokimane's pulled up Pornhub before on.
Oh yeah, yeah,
she has, gave like a fake link, and if you pull up Pornhub, and never got anything for it.
I think
so. It's very weird that he's indefinitely banned.
Exactly. But he has her dick. That's a double standard right there.
I mean, Forsen's like also has like a bunch of bands. So,
But like no, that's definitely a double standard right there. Because like, I think like this whole like Pokimane like drama coming out, like I don't think it deserves a ban, but I think it deserves like a couple of like heads pointed in her direction because she made a slanderous video about a dude, and then. You know, like,
well, it wasn't slanderous because he admitted that he did wrongdoing prior to her video anyways.
No, that's true, but
like he was already excusing himself from the picture entirely, and then they were like, hey, like, we just think it's like better idea if like you don't, I mean, I think he was gonna probably move out anyways, but they're like, hey, we probably think it's like you move out and like just like if you want to come back at some point, like you can come back, but it's like
no. Like, they cut ties, and they told him, we need you to release a statement so it comes out of your mouth. But then as he was like doing drafts of the statement, Offline TV just randomly decided like, okay, like Yvonne, you just drop your statement and we'll just go from there. And then Yvonne dropped a statement, and then he like 15 minutes later. No, it's not speculated. That's what he said in the document. Well, then again, yeah, like, that's his point of view.
Like, yeah. Everybody else could have been like, no, we didn't say that. And he's like, well, yeah, I said that. It's like, well, dude, who the fuck?
Well,
I'm going to say, he didn't have DMs for that, so they can't.
That's true. But the fact that nobody in Offline TV doubted it, nobody hit X for doubt there. They all just, like, brushed over it. So that's why I'm assuming it's true. Because otherwise, like, they would have like pointed and been like, oh well, that's a lie, because like
if you have DMs for everything else but then don't have DMs for the fucking one thing that's just like, oh yeah, 15 minutes before they told me to release, it's like, dude, you really, you're not gonna have a DM for that, and it took you like 4 months already to write this fucking manifesto, like
no, but that's where he couldn't have been done.
He couldn't have been done at that point. He wasn't done with the document, though. Like, it was still like technically being worked on.
No, the document was finished ages ago, though, because like in the beginning
he was still working on it. That was his seventh copy.
Yeah, but in the beginning of the doc it says it's been 2 months, right? And it's been more than 2 months since he's been kicked out of Offline TV. Like in the beginning it says it's been 2 months since I've been kicked out of Offline TV. So
I think that was the last draft before he stopped doing it, at least.
Exactly, yeah.
So it's like he at that point, like, he might have been adding DMs for that part, but then decided not to.
See, because like, here's the thing, I respect the fact that like a bunch of people are coming to his aid, or like not so much like taking his side, but just saying like, yeah, like, because like he never talked about like how he touched Yvonne or Lily, and like he was like,
he admitted to it.
He admitted to it.
Like, why would I even admit to that? He's like, I'm not talking about that shit. He's like, I'm talking about this fucking
bitch
saying slanderous ass shit.
So like
being like
people like Slicker coming out and saying like you know what, he's right, because like when you look at the doc and you look at the screenshots, a lot of it really is like leading him on, and like in his point of view, like he probably thought he and Poki were gonna start dating, and like he even said like Poki had other dudes over, and like these dudes were probably rearranging her guts, like, and this dude's like right next door and he can hear everything. Like that's mentally challenging, you know.
Yeah, but at the same time, like most of the DMs kind of read like, it was like some of them were like that, and then like you would just read some of them, it's just like, bro, like,
cringe. This
chick is just not feeling it, bro. Like,
oh yeah,
you're like, oh, like, want me to come over, and she's like, like, I don't know, like, IDK, like, he, and it's just like, bro, like, here's the, like, stop here, just be like, okay, good night, just leave it at that, bro. And instead he's just like, are you sure, like, are you really and at that point some of the texts make it look like he's pushy, and it's like, dude, oh, this is kind of like, you're kind of like, I read it and I was like, bro, like, desperate. You're kind of, I was like, yeah, I was like, you seem desperate, and like you're incriminating yourself for being pushy on,
yeah.
I was like, this is just mad, like, I'm like, they're like, no one's in the wrong, like, she was interested, and then like you could tell the line where she was disinterested and he still kept being interested, and it's like, dude, just notice that she's not, like, there's just like self-awareness at some point. It's like he just has no self-awareness to realize that she's not interested anymore.
For me, that's, it was literally like copy paste of like the DMs I had with that girl I was talking about earlier, the one that I had my first kiss with. Like, that's essentially what it was like. Like, she would, like, one week she would be 100% into me and like talking about like all this and that, and then like the next day she would just be like really dry or whatever. But like the one thing I wanted to point out where like all the inconsistencies really fell for me and I was like, I feel like Poki is faking a lot of this, was so Fed went on Raj's show, the Rochelorette or the Rochler or whatever, right? And remember how that chick Kate won, and then she was like, Fed, I think you're ugly. Like, there was,
yeah, that shit was cringe when they all won. It was just cringe in general.
So essentially, the chick who won the show, Fed chose her, but she chose host, right? So she chose not to like date him or anything, and she said that like, oh, it's because you're ugly and you're unattractive. And so a bunch of Fed's friends, a bunch of Fed's friends jumped into the call and they were starting to defend him, which, you know, I would probably do too, because like, that's not cool. Like, you don't need to call him ugly, you already won the show.
You don't need to disrespect him online.
Yeah, but it's like the whole point of the show is like everyone's an actor, like no one's really being themselves, like it's all fake shit. So it's like, if she calls him ugly, like, talk about it later, just be like, hey, like, did you actually fucking mean that? Like, that was kind of like, that was
she probably did though. she was really drunk.
Just be like, bro, that's kind of fucked up. Like, why'd you say that? Like, you don't have to say it right then and there. Like, just pretend it's a joke. Like, pretend it's a persona. And then she's like, oh, dude, no, like, I was totally kidding. Like, I just thought it would be like a good thing to say because like people are just gonna get like mad and then like defend you later. Be like, oh, look at this bitch. She's like, it's just good for both of us. But then instead, everyone freaks out.
But like, that's where the whole like thing comes in, because like Poki jumped into the call and Poki started white knighting Fed. So, and I'm thinking back to the timestamps, because in her video she was saying around that time was when they found out about the whole Yvonne situation, right? Because it, like, Offline TV knew about it, but they were still deciding what to do, right?
Well, and no, so, because according to Fed, she knew earlier than that.
Exactly, right? So like, they knew is what I'm saying, right? And so this whole Kate thing happens, but Poki still jumps into the call to defend him. Like, if you're so disgusted by this guy and so scared of him, like, doing X, Y, and Z, why would you defend him when someone's calling him ugly? Just leave it, right? Like, just mind your own business. Do whatever you want to do. Mm-hmm. But she's jumping in to defend him. So, from that, I can see, like, the whole, like, back and forth thing where, like, one day she's really into him and, like, she's defending his honor or whatever. And then the next day she's just like, yeah, he's a scumbag, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but to be honest, all these messages are from 2018.
Yeah,
so she's not into him today.
No, like, definitely.
Like 2019, 2020.
No, so,
like,
for nothing, sure.
Nothing of how they feel to this day like reflects what they like reflects their relationship before.
True. But like,
which is what Fed was trying to say.
And exactly.
He was trying to say. Also, she was like, bro, like, these are from like 2 years ago when we first met. She was like, this is not how we talk to or interact with each other to this day. Like, these are not our texts today. She's like, this is 2 years ago, buddy. Like, type shit.
Three years ago. I definitely see the whole like thing about the like flirty relationship like going down and like them not being like that anymore, but like the parts of like the whole ruthless businesswoman part, like I still see that happening where like she'll just randomly like DM him, because like not all of the DMs have the timestamp with the date, right? So like I'm assuming the ones about like Yvonne not being up to par with her work and stuff were probably late 2019 or early 2020.
Yeah, but those ones were, like, really professional texts. Like, those had, like, there were nothing flirty in those texts.
Exactly.
Like, those were, like, very professional. Like, both sides were being professional. Nothing in there was just, like, oh, like, yeah, like, do you want to, like, come into my room and, like, talk about it? Like, it wasn't, like, that shit. It was just, like, hey, like, what's up with the situation? Like, how are we doing right now? Like, we're running a business.
Bless you. Whoever's blowing your nose, you're a cunt.
Yeah, bless you.
Oh, shit. I thought I pressed the mute button. I'm sorry.
Yeah. And you know what? You're ugly. You're ugly and you're unattractive.
Yeah, you're unattractive, bro. Dude.
Oh my god. Dude.
I'm kidding. Okay. Klaus is a beautiful man.
Sunshine. Don't worry, I'll defend you. I'll be your white knight.
Dude, did you just jump into this
Bryce.
Call?
Yo, did you just jump into this call?
You just jumped in here. Oh my god, is that Bryce? The Bryce?
Is it? Bro,
we need Aiden to jump into the call. We need Aiden to white light me, jump into the call.
Exactly, dude. I think, like, yo, Aiden, what are you doing, man? That was your prime moment to jump in and just defend this guy and come after my personal character.
Dude, yeah, say, watch my boo. Where's my honey? You know, like, God damn.
I was gonna say, watch Pokimane all of a sudden jumps in and just and is just like, what did you just say about
actually?
And you'd be like, what the fuck, Pokimane? How did you fucking get in here? I didn't know you're part of the server.
Damn.
But yeah, I think at the end of the day, what happened between them, that's their personal shit. I don't care. But I think that we, like, because Poki Simps defended her straight up when she literally mentally abused this guy for a while. Like, I don't know about recently, right? But, like, for that time, like, this dude was getting strung along because he was under the 100% impression that they would end up dating eventually. But they didn't, right?
Yeah, but anybody you watch any day, like, you're gonna defend. Like, whether, whether these guys, like, you call them simps, but, like, some of them probably genuinely watch her because, like, they like her content.
Hey, yo, Evan. Just, like, Evan, thanks for stopping by, brother. We'll catch you later.
Sir. And dropping this up.
I'll just say something real quick.
Oh, yo, yeah, Evan. Later, dude. Sorry to interrupt the stream.
You're actually...
I said to say later, Evan, guys. Sorry about that.
Shout out, you know.
But
yo, it was Vim who interrupted this time. Relax.
I just want to thank him because he subbed. You know, hey, yeah. Let me tell you, if you sub, you get extra love. That's all I'm saying, man.
Anyways, Klaus, you're saying
I only dumb.
Yeah, I wanted to say, you know that Pokemon shit. Before you were saying, what was it? You were talking about how she's doing something. Oh fuck! It was about the flirting and everything.
Manipulating
along. Oh, no, it was the fact that she came in to defend him, right?
Oh yeah,
and you thought that was sus.
Yeah, white knight.
Honestly, I would probably pin it to more that most people don't care about bad things happening until they, like, have to be accountable for it. True. Like, until people know, yeah. And they're held to standards by society, they just don't care. She probably didn't care, you know. They just use it as fucking drama and to look good to audiences.
Oh, 100%. Because at the end of the day, like I said, she's a ruthless businesswoman, man. Anything for the views. Anything to farm that content. And, like, that's one of the things that I was thinking, where it's, like, the whole folky ship, right? It was farming so many views, and she was getting so many viewers, and they were sharing viewers. Part of me thinks that she kept stringing him along partially for the whole folky content stuff. Right?
Probably.
So, hey, you know what? If I had a girlfriend, I would put her on stream all the time because I could farm easy views, and, like, you guys could be like, oh, old Vim wouldn't have ever done this. Like, Vim would have been like, shut up, woman, or something like that, and, like,
shut up, whammon.
Exactly, there you go,
whammon.
Oh, I'd never do it. I'd be like, yo, get out of, I'd be like, yo, okay, you're gonna get out of the room now. I'm playing a single player co-op game, and I'm gonna listen to the story, and if you distract me, I'm going to tell you to leave. I'm gonna make you leave. Okay,
true.
That's how it is, dude.
No way.
Bro, you story, were, bro. Story be better than bro. Bro, if I'm streaming straight, and story, and then, dude, bro, if, like, if I'm streaming, it's like, bro, like, I'm at work right now. Like, if you're with me at work, like, I wouldn't, you know.
True, that's actually true.
Like, dude, if you want me to make money? Like, let me play this game. Like,
so what you're telling me is,
if I want you in here, I'll call you.
So what you're telling me is Maya Higa is actually taking away from Mizkif's content. There you go.
But she streams too, though.
It's all women's fault, dude.
Yeah, facts.
So when, like, when she's, yeah, yeah, but she's in, if she's in women. His, if she's in, women. Most of her viewers are his.
Oh, true. That is true.
They share viewers. Dude.
That's true.
It doesn't even matter.
Yo, you know what I just remembered? I think I low-key forgot it. Oh, no. Eric's tweet from earlier today, right? Eric made a beautiful tweet.
He was like,
you women really be out here saying support small local businesses. And then you go out to your local Cadillac Fairview Mall for a retail therapy. Yikes. True. Okay, you guys didn't get that.
Wait, no. Well, because I don't know what the fucking Cadillac.
No, that's mall. Like the.
So, like, it's like a mall chain, like, yeah, in Canada.
I assumed.
Yeah, so, like, it's essentially like big corporation malls. Like, think like the biggest mall that you have, like, in your city. Like, that's a Cadillac Fairview Mall.
Yeah, no. Dude, it would have been better to if you said, like, if you made, like, super specific, like, just like you talk about, like, support small businesses, but every morning go to Starbucks.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Like, bro, like, fucking small. Yeah, bro, I go to my local small business Starbucks every single day. Like, what the fuck?
But like for Eric though, his demographic is like Canadian dudes, right? So, like, that makes sense. But but more onto the topic, it's like all these girls nowadays, all these woke social justice warrior left-leaning females, they're always spamming their stories saying support the small local businesses. And dude, Canada's going as far as making the Black Pages, which is going to be a phone book filled with Black owned businesses, right? So like he's essentially saying like all these people who act woke, at the end of the day, they're still just going to go to the big corporations and spend their money and ruin their credit score.
No, it's not even that. I've been mad about this since I saw it. It was like, oh, like go support these black businesses. I'm just like, bro, like I'm going to be real with you. I'm not supporting this Black business because it fucking sucks. Not because it's Black, but because a fucking business is trash. Yo. Like, I don't care that it's owned by a Black guy. It's like, I didn't go there before because it was trash. I'm not going to go there now just because the guy who owns it is Black. I hate white people businesses too, like small white people businesses. Like, bro, dude, like, I'm not gonna go to small businesses because they fucking suck. Like, get a better business. Maybe it won't be small anymore. Dumb fucks. Fucking hell, bro. I've been mad about this for so long. Like, yo, dumbass little people being like, oh my god, like I go to my local like Indian like place. It's like, okay, like if they made better food, maybe I'd go too. What the fuck, dude? Like, sorry, you eat when you're hungover and it's fucking shit.
Oh my god.
I was subtweeting people I know.
I like that. No. You keep going. Keep going, man.
That's pretty much it.
I 100% agree with you.
Right? Like, dude, I don't go to businesses. I don't go to big businesses because they fucking suck too.
Yeah, no, exactly. Like, yo, if your business is good, we're gonna go support your business. If it's trash, leave it in the dust. Kick rocks, bro.
And here's the thing. It all comes down to also like the cost and the work that they do. Like, let's say I go to an embroidery service or like someplace to do the merch, right? And they tell me that like per each unit, it would be this much money. So you would be making X profit and I would be making Y profit, right? So like if I go to them and they tell me like that it would be so expensive to do stuff, why would I want to do business with you, right? Where I can find a better, cheaper option, right? And I don't care what race you are. If I find a better option to take my business to, like I'm going to do that, right? So like then I go to the next person and like they're offering me like a cheaper option or like a better quality option, right? Then I'm obviously going to choose them, and if that happens to be a big retailer, I'm gonna do that. I just think it's funny because women, you know.
Oh, okay, yeah. Sorry, I should have said that. Yeah, because all these women are saying you go to women. Small businesses, bro. Sorry, I forgot to add that part into my rant.
Fuck women.
Here's the whole double standard part of it. It's because they'll say this, but they'll never do it themselves. You know what I mean?
Yeah. No, I know mad people. No, I know all the people that I know that say support small businesses actually go like and support small businesses.
Okay, well,
They're like a niche where they live currently. There's like all the businesses are locally owned by people, so it's like
okay.
Like it profits off of this state that they live in, like Vermont, is like Vermont's like whole thing is just like, we support like our local businesses. Like, we don't like big chains are here, but it's like we would rather have like it grown here, made here, like everything's like in-state type shit. But that's just like the state's way of like doing it, of very supportive of local shit. So all right, like, then they're all local shit. But it's like people in Boston, like I don't see, like if they're like, oh my god, support local businesses, it's like, shut the fuck up, bitch. Like, I know you're going to fucking Newberry Street and going to Starbucks and going like all these fucking big businesses, you dumb fuck.
All right, then what about this? What about all the women who have like throughout this entire like year have been reposting about donate to this charity, but you know for a fact they didn't donate a single penny themselves. Bro, they're just reposting.
I know they donated like $5. It's like, bitch, I'm using that $5 to pay my fucking rent. Like, you're living at home or living at fucking college. Like, shut the fuck. Like, and being like, if you don't like. I'm paying, like, I know you can too. It's like, yo, I'm trying to save my money and spend it on myself. Like, I don't care about these other people. Like, if I did, I would have donated. Like, I'm trying to get I'm trying to get my money up. Like, I'm not trying to get their money up. Like, what the fuck? And I'm not like a non-charitable person, but it's like, if I have the money to donate, you know what I mean? Like, all the people that have like money to donate, or like, not that. Oh, what the fuck am I talking about?
Dude, Uncaged Pierre is so good.
Dude, okay. All the people that have money to donate will donate it. Where it's like, if I don't have them, if I barely have enough money to take care of myself, why the fuck am I, like, why would I donate, like, my grocery money to fucking, like, save a child? Like, no offense to the child, but it's like, bro, like, yo, get your, like, if this child,
someone else could do it better, to be honest.
Where it's like all these big business owners could also donate their money, or like all these millionaires, like all these doctors who are making so much money that, like, dude, doctors used to work for free. Like, doctors used to be considered poor in the old days. Like, they would go and, like, they'd fix your heart, and like the mother of, like, the kid you just fixed, you'd be like, oh, like, here, I'll make you dinner, and they'd be like, oh, okay, cool, thank you. Like, it's a public service. Like, it's like, doctors shouldn't be rich.
Damn,
but that's a different rant. That's completely separate.
That's a good topic for next week.
That's very different, though.
I do want to point out that I forgot completely what I was gonna say.
Okay, you're irrelevant. You're canceled. Get out of here.
Oh wait, what was I talking about before I talked about that?
Oh, okay. No. I figured it out. It's that people who are in these higher like tax brackets are the people who should be donating, dude. People in middle class brackets, you need to start worrying about your own friggin' financial stability, man. Like, stop trying to donate to, like, all these charitable causes. Of course, like, if you want to do that, that sounds like,
go ahead and do that.
But, like, at the end of the day, don't be complaining that, damn, I can't pay my bills. Like, hey, we get it. Yeah. Like,
don't donate. Say, oh, I can't pay my bills. And then be like, oh, why the fuck didn't you donate? It's like, because, bitch, I'm paying my bills. Like, what the fuck?
Exactly. Get your money up, not your funny up.
Yo, get your bread up, fam.
Facts. True.
Get that bread. Get that head, then bread.
I mean, like, and if I'm going to do something for someone, like, if I'm going to, like, do charitable work, like, I'm gonna do it, like, personally myself, like, in person, go help people.
Yeah. True. I think,
like,
that's,
like,
I've done
shit, like, in person, like, give up my, like, not even, like, my money, like, I'm giving up, like, my time of my
exactly.
day. Like, it literally takes two, like, all these people being like, it takes 2 minutes to donate. It's like, okay, well, it took me 5 hours to help this fucking, like, 5 hours to do, like, whatever thing I did.
Yeah, like, okay. Work at a homeless shelter
and it was, like, whatever, like, $3 for gas for me to drive there. Like, I probably did more than you donating $1 to an organization that's just gonna fucking pay their people, because they have to be nonprofit.
Exactly. True. No, I 100% agree with that. If you donate your time, it's definitely probably more worthwhile than donating, like, $5. Whereas, like, if you're super rich, if you donated $500,000, that's gonna be a lot more effective than, let's say, Pierre's 5 hours, right?
Yeah.
So, like, again, it comes down to, like, your tax bracket, which I feel is weird, because, like, all these girls that I see, like, posting this shit, like, I know they work at, like, McDonald's, dude. I know you don't have the money to pay your own car bill. Like, your mommy's paying your car for you. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah, true. I know their parents have money. I know their parents are in a higher tax bracket.
Oh, my God. I absolutely hate these people. Like, and it's usually, like, girls again, because, like, I don't see dudes, like, flexing their mom and dad's money, but
bro, I was just like, yo, guys, Black Lives Matter, but also check out this post that I have that has my Gucci belt.
Exactly. I hate that.
What the fuck are you talking about?
And then, like, dude, I know all these girls, because, like, in the area I live in Stony Creek, which is, like, a part of Hamilton, and, like, it's filled with a lot of pretentious women, and so, like, all these women, I know for a fact they've had cars since they were 16, and I'm not talking about, like, Honda Civics, I'm talking about, like, Mercedes, like, I'm talking about BMWs, like, I'm talking about, like, higher end or middle class cars, whatever you want to call them.
Yeah, right.
And so, well, like, but
it's like higher middle class.
It's like you don't need this car as a 16-year-old.
It's not a fucking bomb of a car.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You guys get the point. You guys get the point.
My first car was a fucking bomb.
It's not from fucking 2002. Like, this is, like, current day meta.
But you guys get the point. Meta. They're 16. They clearly, like, should not be on the road on their own for long periods of time, but they have these expensive ass cars that mommy and daddy bought them. But at the end of the day, they'll cry if, like, you know, they don't have enough money for, like, the new iPhone or something. Like, dude, like, come on, man. Like, I worked two jobs over the summer to get the car that I have now. I'm completely happy with it, and I'm working my ass off to pay for it, right? I did that all by myself with none of my parents' help, right? So, like, you don't see me crying for money unless it's on twitch.tv/the_uncle_vim, like, Twitch Prime, Amazon job, Prime, whatever job. You want to do. Like, I butchered the line, but hey, like, you know.
That's fine.
Yeah, true.
I mean, I became an escort and completely was it studied in Sydney, which is one of the biggest places in Australia in terms of cost of living.
Exactly.
All by myself without any...
There you go. Mm. Look at Bryce. Like, he gave up his cock, dude. For that money.
Had to sell dick by
No, I gave up my sanity was more what it was.
You gave up sanity.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to be honest, Vim. I think you just described me, though.
What do you mean?
I don't own my car.
Okay, you're not.
It wasn't bought for me, though.
No, but you're not like one of those people who are just always crying about money.
Oh, no, I'm not complaining.
Exactly. No. Like, you work hard for the stuff you have. Like, you're living on your own now, or like, you're still living with your sister, but like, it's essentially on your own. You're living.
Well, I'm paying my rent.
Exactly. You're paying your own rent. You're paying for your own food.
Yeah. My mom pays her rent.
Still relatively independent.
Exactly. You're independent. You're not living off of your parents, right? So,
I gotta go shopping tomorrow. Thank you for reminding me.
Oh, crap. I got you, brother.
You're welcome.
But, Erik, brother, tell us some stuff you hate about women, my man.
I just don't like how they're hypocrites.
Oh, you give us some examples of
hypocrisy. I mean, humans are hypocrites in general.
To be honest, so are men.
True. Yeah, you're right.
Oh my god, here's Tracy, dude. She comes in at the right time. Erik, take it away, dude. Give us some examples of hypocrisy.
Oh. Okay, I have to think about this. I have to think very deep. Very deep. Okay, so, for example, at the gym, you know how girls hate when you look at their body, you know? True.
So why are they wearing tight-ass clothes?
Okay, you can't say that. You can't say that.
Wait, why can't you say that?
No, because the narrative is that girls should be allowed to wear whatever they want and feel comfortable and whatever.
True.
Wait, that's true, though.
Yeah.
Especially guys. Also, right?
Yeah, and so, but yeah, what I was trying to say is like, yo, I have all these shorties that are either like eyeing me down or eyeing other people down, and then they're either talking shit or talking something, and like, yo, what's the deal here? What's the deal here?
I don't understand what you just said.
Yeah, nothing you said forms.
No, okay. So you know how
again me reiterating why people don't like people from Toronto.
Come on, man. Come on. Okay, no. Okay, I think what Erik means to say is that he doesn't like the double standard of like when he eyes a girl at the gym, she'll be like, "You misogynistic pig, how dare you look at me like that?" But then like there'll be girls that like stare at Erik all the time. Like, I think that's
like
what
another guy, yeah.
Or another guy, like, yeah. Like, they'll be thirsting.
I caught some shorties in the gym recording other guys.
Yo, did you call them out?
Did the guys notice, though?
No, they didn't notice. The guys didn't notice. I noticed.
Yeah, see? So that means, that means they're being sneaky with it. If a girl catches you looking at them, then you're not being slick with it. Like, you deserve to be caught.
Yeah, but like,
and you deserve to be called out. Like, if he caught them, like, I swear, guarantee you, if that guy caught them recording, he walks up and says something.
No,
maybe,
I doubt it.
Maybe.
I don't doubt it. Yeah, well, you gotta be careful, man. Like, you guys think, like, you single, like, you want to work out together, like, and when he's hitting on them, we're being like, yo, can you like stop? Like, I'm trying to like fucking lift here.
Yeah,
bro, that happened to me once at the gym, like recently actually, where like I went and like this girl was like straight up recording me. I'm like, hello, like, why are you recording? Like, she's like texting on her phone, and next thing you know, she's like holding it like this, and like I know for a fact, like, this is not an angle to take a selfie, right? Like, so I know she's like recording me doing whatever. I'm like, why are you recording me, dude? And she's just like, oh, I wasn't. And I'm like, okay, like, can you please like fuck off, like, because I'm trying to like focus on my workout. And she got mad, but you know.
Yeah, see, like, my friend who I said earlier, like, he works out a lot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
when he goes to the gym, like, he likes it when people stare at him, because then that energizes him, that he knows he's big, because you're staring at him because he's fucking huge. So he's like, dude, he's like, I want you to take video. Like, he doesn't tell them that, but it's like a mental thing. Yeah, like, he'll see it in the mirror and be like, fuck yeah, dude, I'm about to go fucking hard as shit. Like, I'm about to go up in weight now.
Oh, exactly.
Like, yeah, he does that. Like, it energizes him. Like, he gets fucking like hard at when people stare at him. Like,
for me,
even if it's another guy, like, he doesn't give a fuck.
Bro, if it's other dudes looking at me and hyping me up, I enjoy that. Like, there's this one dude at the gym. Like, whenever I go to hit three plates on bench, he's always like, "Let's go, buddy, let's go." And then like, whether I actually get it or I fail or whatever, like, he's still super supportive, and like that, like the whole like gym brotherhood thing, right? But like, women will be like just looking at me, and I feel like like so self-conscious. I'll be thinking like, oh, they're probably thinking like, oh, like what's this dude doing? Like, he looks so ugly right now or whatever. Like, oh my god, did he come out of like a sewer drain or something? Like, I don't know. Yeah, it might just be me.
They can't even put up one plate, bro. They're going there doing fucking squats. Like,
no, bro, they're going there to take pictures in their Gymshark uniform and then go home.
Okay. Can you disagree with me? They're just going there to do squats. Let's be real.
They're going to do squats, yeah, but they're going to do legs.
They're getting a nice ass.
Legs, booty, abs.
Yeah, that's all the women do. Yeah, that's all the women do.
And then maybe they'll either run on the treadmill, do the bike, or do the elliptical.
Hey, yo, shout out Faith Pacioli. It's one of my best friends right there.
They'll get those engorged muscles and just take pics in the mirror and just be like, yes.
Yeah, no, dude. Me normally. Eric was talking about that a while ago. Where like he, whenever I show him like a cute girl that I meet at the gym, he just be like, "Yep, that's just another white girl who knows how to show off her butt."
It's the pose. Like, they put one leg in front of the other, and it makes their ass look big.
True.
Yeah, that's all it is.
Like, hey, dude. What can I say? Some people just know how to work it. Some people know how to twerk it. Uncle Vim 2020.
All
right, so Vim, next time somebody's staring at you and it's a girl, just be like, bro, I'm gonna fuck up these plates real quick.
Sure. There is like
some... Because then you get in the psychological where it's like, damn, like, I don't care if they're ugly or like gross, like, they're looking at me like, now I gotta fucking flex this shit. Even if I don't do it, and like, but I'm like I'm attempting it, like, that's more effort than like these fucking skinny ass, like, machine gun Kelly ass. They be in there doing the machines. No offense to people that do the machines, but like,
I'm not gonna lie. There are times where like I'll actually get hyped when girls look at me, and then there are times where I'll just be like disgusted. So like, there's this one.
Probably in a bad mood already, though.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't really know.
It's just a confidence thing, man. But get in the right headspace. Just don't care. Fuck them.
But like, there's this one girl that I worked out with for a while. I haven't seen her in a while because the capacity at the gym went down because of COVID. But she and I were actually really cool. We started getting to know each other because we both like lift very, very heavy. And she found me on Instagram. She followed me, and I was like, okay, bet. And like, she's really cool. Like, I honestly thought she was hitting on me for a while too, because like, she came up to me randomly one day. Like, I go into the gym and she's like, oh, I was looking for you today. And I was like, she was looking for me?
You're like what? She's like, yeah, I need someone to, yeah, she's like, I just need someone to spot me. And like, yeah,
that is what happened.
Oh, no, okay, yeah, because I was gonna say, because you're probably the biggest guy there for like when she's there.
True. But
so it's like, she knows that like, it's not gonna fucking fall on her, and she's gonna fucking break her neck.
Damn, bro, are my stories getting predictable? I need to start rehearsing my stories in the shower again, so I can make them unpredictable.
That's kind of weird.
That's just what I thought, though.
But and then there's like these other girls that look like freaking Moto Moto's girlfriend, Gloria, or whatever her name was from Madagascar. Right?
Yeah, Gloria.
And like, they'll like try to talk to me, or like they'll be staring at me. I'll just be like, yeah, I'm kind of busy right now. Like, follow me on Twitch or something like that. Like, you know what I mean? Because like, I'm also kind of worried, because like, starting, I think next week, I want to start IRL streaming at the gym. Like, my drive to the gym and my drive
back. Yeah, you have to talk to the gym people first and be like, hey, like, I want to like live stream like my workouts. Like, is it okay that I do that? Like,
yeah, they said
like some places get really fucking mad. And no, they're like, yo, like, what the fuck are you doing?
They said it was cool, so long as like, I'm obviously not maliciously recording. So like, I'm not trying to like upskirt women or something like that.
Yeah, it's like an angle where it's just like,
yeah,
basically
like,
it's you and only you, or as much.
Yeah,
as
they said just make sure like the camera angle is just me, and if I have to have other people in it, just make sure that like it's focused solely on me. And like, if there is other people there, then like try not to film it or whatever. But
yeah.
Well, but you like, got like 10 people in the gym, it should be
exactly
easy.
Exactly.
Yeah, actually, yeah.
And like, probably, and like, most of the people that are the 10 people, like, probably like see you there, so they're not gonna be like, oh, this dude's trying to like what the fuck are you doing, bro?
Exactly.
Yeah. Stop recording.
Like, I'm just working out, like, I'm trying to like, all right, like, I'll just turn the camera, bro. Like, my bad.
You know what really pisses me off at the gym right now? There, it's 10 people capacity, but in the women's change room, it leads to another section of the gym, which is like women only, and they have 5 spots there, right? So those 5 spots are almost always gone, because like some of the real women, they'll actually go in and book those spots, right? But what I noticed the last couple weeks is that those spots are open and the main floor is all booked up, and then like the one day I got in and there was female spots open and the main floor was booked, I got in and it was me, two dudes, and eight women.
That's 11 people.
What do you mean?
Exactly. So you know what happened? The one person who booked in the women's place came out onto the main floor.
Okay.
And so eight women, dude, five of them could have been in the women's gym, and that would have meant five more people, whether they're guys or girls, could have came in to work out. But they decided, I'm gonna book the main floor, screw the women's only spot.
Wait. I don't understand what happens. Wait, so I don't get it.
Okay, so like, fair, at the gym,
they could just be thinking like, I'm not gonna get those private spots or something, or I don't really care, you know.
Wait, so how did they get to be 11? Because like the women didn't get booked up, so the one woman that was in there came to the main floor to work out.
Exactly, yeah. She snuck into the main floor
because she knew she couldn't get in, so she booked the woman's spot and then just walked in.
Exactly. Yeah. There you go.
Wait, how did they allow that then?
They don't walk around keeping yeah. head count, right? You should be like, hey,
I wait to book this spot, and like I saw this person walk in from that place where they booked. Like,
man, I ain't no snitch. You get me,
bro? That's not snitching. That's like I pay for membership here.
That's true, but
if you're not paying and you're snitching, like that's different. Like, but like if you're paying monthly and it's like not, and like, dude, if I'm going into a place like buy food, like I'm not gonna be like, hey, and like you guys have like over your 30 person capacity in here, like like that's kind of like I think I'm gonna get a COVID now from that. Like, now it's just like, bro, like you're being a fucking dweeb, like shut the fuck up.
Yeah, but I think it's really stupid.
Yeah, if you're paying to use the gym and like you wait for that spot and like you wake up like at 12 a.m like 12 I mean like if you wake up like
yeah. I wake midnight, up at like 6 like, 5 6 a.m
oh no, I'm saying if you wake up at
so
midnight
you go out
like,
of your way.
Yeah, I'm saying if like no, I'm saying like if you like you're like waiting to like right when it opens, you're booking.
Oh like, crap! I gotta book.
See, like this, like somebody could just get your somebody could just like fuck you like this, like somebody could just fuck you over right now.
Yeah,
because it's 11:59, so at midnight, like he has to book. So it's like some person. I there could be an 11. There could be like pace like the days you don't get in, like somebody could be just taking your spot because they booked in the women's and walk in.
Yeah. Basically,
yes. Yeah, exactly. So you gotta tell them that you're like, hey, like I've noticed a couple of times, like I've seen people come over from like the woman's only side, and like they work out on the main floor. Like I think, like it's kind of catchy. Like, I wait till midnight to book this, so I guarantee a spot.
True.
It's midnight, by the way.
And I think that something that's really sus is that
did you book? It's midnight.
I'm trying to like it's getting a lot of requests. Like it's loading. It's literally getting too many server requests. Everyone's like up right now trying to book. Okay, can I get in? Seven spots left. Booking your class.
Will he clutch it out, boys? Will Vim clutch it out?
Is it working, guys?
Will he clutch out
the spot? Dude, it's on you, bro.
Will he clutch it?
I know for a fact there's people right now trying to get in because it's usually 10 spots available, but it says 7 spots left and it just turned 12.
See, for me, there's 40 spots available every single day.
Dang.
Yeah.
I don't think I got it, boys. I think I'm screwed. Rough. But
try to do the women's only.
It says an error. Try doing the women's. No, because on the list it'll say like where you booked for, right? So like if I booked on the women's, they'd be like, Vim, why are you in like the women's section? And I'd just be like,
I identify as a woman. I identify as a woman. Yeah.
Like, bro, they can't do shit. There's no way they'll have a go at you.
Yeah, I'd be feeling real feminine today.
Yeah.
I think
you look so retentive by grace.
Well,
oh, I got it, boys. I got it.
That's my boy.
Squad dub, boys. Squad dub.
Yo, Vim.
What's up, brother?
It's my man's.
Vimmy Daddy.
We secured the bag, boys.
We secured it.
See, imagine if you didn't
just got me.
Imagine if you didn't get in and some woman walked over to the main floor.
I know. Yeah, I'm about to gatekeep the gym floor.
See, you wouldn't know because you weren't there.
Exactly.
Somebody stole your spot and she got in as the 11th. Maybe even the 12th.
But
Well, is there even a difference between like the like a main, like in for the machines and stuff or whatever.
So what
is there even the big difference between the two?
I'm assuming that they have pretty much everything in there except a couple things, because like obviously the main floor has a wide assortment of machines. I'm assuming the women's only section has free weights for sure, probably one Smith machine because leg day goals, it's hump day ladies, right? And then I'm assuming they have the bare minimum in there, right? But like dude, there's 5 open spots for women only, right? Please encourage your female Patreons to go and book those spots and work out in the female gym so you can allow more people to book on the main floor. That's all I'm saying. I think that's it's true. Fair.
Also, did you mean to say patrons?
Patron, yeah, but he said Patreons on purpose.
Yeah.
I said Patreons.
Wait, did you mean... Okay,
I meant so patrons. I said Patreons.
Sorry. English ducks popped on in and my brain was like, what?
I was thinking about women and I said Patreon instead of patron.
No, woman, he went OnlyFans, Patreon. Okay, it's got to be Patreon then.
Oh my god.
Yeah, one check mark. True, though,
like, if there's like, out of like the 5 people that book, if there's like 2 guys and like 8 women on the main floor out of the 10, it's like, why didn't 5 of them just book the women's?
And then exactly.
8 more people in. Or like 3, whatever.
Yeah, I think it's a different story if the women's thing is fully booked with 5 and then there's only 2 men on the floor and like the rest of them are women. I think that's completely different because that means that the women's gym is already booked, right? But I just feel like if there's spots open in the women's only section and you're booking on the main floor as a woman, you literally hate all men. That's why I think. I feel like you're one of those kill all men people.
Nah, if she's like a big ass, if she's like some chick that's like lifting heavy, like I mean heavy.
Okay,
like
that's a different story. Different
because then she's like, she's one of the boys.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
She's one of the homies.
Like, she's going hard and like she's like, yo, like.
Vampire. No, she is a boy. Like
she's like, oh.
Yeah, she.
Bruh. She's a boy.
She's been reassigned gender.
I just mean like you would be like, hey, like, yo, can you spot me, bro?
Yeah, no, I know what you mean. But like,
Do you need a spot? Like, if they're doing that to you, then it's like, okay, they belong on the main floor. Like,
exactly.
I think people should be free weights only. If you're on the main floor, free weights, you're a fucking bitch. Like, you're a pussy.
I've also noticed like there are a lot of like women who just like they book in the female only section and they stay there, and you know what, mad props to them, mad props.
Sorry to interrupt, but I got a dip.
You know what, it's actually past time anyway, so we're gonna end pretty soon.
I'll push it off for a bit then.
Finish your story, Vim.
But yeah, anyways, my whole thing is that, you know, women belong in the kitchen. They shouldn't be allowed to vote.
Oi!
And when I become Prime Minister of Canada, I'm gonna be taking away all their rights.
Yeah, I
don't think that was a joke.
Yo, if Jim became Prime Minister, he'd get shot on sight.
I probably would, by a woman.
In GTA, probably.
By a woman.
In GTA Online.
Anyways, I'm completely kidding. I love and respect women, and I'm seeing a very awesome girl right now. So, anyways, that's a story for next week.
At the end of the day, we all appreciate women here.
Exactly.
Is that right?
Exactly. Hey, dude, I'm a simp, dude. I had to talk. I asked the girl that I'm talking to right now. I'm like, hey, can I go on and like blast the female gender on my podcast? And she's like, you know what? Go for it. But that's a story for next week. It's a story for next week. Don't worry. Next week, the ultimate reveal, Vim's girlfriend. See you then.
Wait, yo, you said girlfriend.
Yikes, bro. Okay. Yikes, bro. It's over. All right.
We're sending
Eric,
that to
Eric.
Her.
Go ahead and
before we before we go, shout out to Evan. You know, just quick shout out. To
Evan's not even here right now. Shout out Evan. You
know? Hey, yo, shout out to Evan. Hold on. I think I'm getting intel from him right now. Evan left.
Evan.
Hold on. I'm getting the intel.
He said it was a good episode, guys. He said this. He said the audio sounds good. That Eric might have to do a couple edits.
Definitely got to do the edits.
I think it was only one, maybe one major edit is what Evan said.
Yeah. Tough. Anyways, Eric, completely. Start us off on the outros, brother.
Yeah. Ayo. So, appreciate you guys for watching, listening, whatever you're doing right now. Hope you live a prosperous life, and thank you for listening to the BattriCast.
Hello?
Yeah?
Oh, shit. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay. Yo, I'm in trouble. All right. Yo, Pierre, shout yourself out.
Pierre.
Yep. OBO boys.
Yep, OBO boys, facts.
Yep. Right, Bryce. Shout out Bryce. Hey, shout out Bryce. Bryce, you're welcome to come back again. Next week too. I love you, brother. And shout out Klaus.
Shout out Klaus.
Hey, this has been your boy Vim. Thank you for listening to the BattriCast. We'll be back next week. I'm screwed. I'm in
fantastic outro, boys.